acquitted. He's now suing the agencies for their participation in depriving him of his liberty. The Liberty Beat is made possible by Justice Ranveer's Bitcoinism.liberty.me. Thoughts on Bitcoin and the future digital economy. Check out the blog at Bitcoinism.liberty.me. Support also comes from My Magic Mud, detoxifying tooth powder, the most effective and affordable dental care around. Get a 150 application jar at MyMagicMud.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 6, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. A new study published in the Journal of Neuroscience has found that daily cannabis use is not connected to brain shrinkage when the effects of alcohol consumption are considered. Neuroscientists at the University of Colorado at Boulder reviewed scientific papers that concluded cannabis use caused parts of the brain to shrink and found the studies were not consistent. By matching daily cannabis users with non-users based on alcohol consumption, the researchers were able to account for the influence of alcohol on brain shrinkage. They found no measurable difference in the size of the brain between those who consumed cannabis daily and those who did not. Nearly 2 years after the Austin Police Department shot and killed Julian Reyes's dog Shinerbach, he continues the fight for justice. In April 2013, Reyes and Shinerbach were confronted by police who were responding to a call for suspicious activity at a local storage unit. Austin police said Shinerbach was growling and would not listen to commands, so the officer shot the dog for protection. Since that time, Reyes has said he has been attacked by police and arrested by police for filming. In a Facebook post, Reyes asked for help from the community, stating, quote, "My time has been spent fighting for justice and change, and I cannot continue without help." Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Want to reach tens of thousands of like-minded listeners every day with your messenger product? The Liberty Beat is looking for sponsors for their daily news service. Support this grassroots media project while expanding your reach to a targeted market. To find out more, just go online to thelibertybeat.com/advertise. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 6, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
America is at a crossroads on many issues, leading many to ask, is it time for the president to blow the silver horn left behind by the founding fathers in case the country ever needed them? Of course, the horn, which has been sitting in the Oval Office since 1817, has never been used by a commander-in-chief, but many Americans think now might be the time to summon our forefathers. Which founding fathers would come back?
All of them. Look, when you have a bug problem, you call the exterminator. When you have an America problem, you call the founding fathers. They know what to do.
We have to keep in mind the founding fathers left us with a warning. If you blow the horn with less than pure intentions, it will turn to tin and can never be used.
But a president has to take risks, have the courage to admit that his administration is not all-knowing, and blow that magic silver horn to summon someone who is.
Yes, but what if we become too reliant on them and they disappear after the next new moon, as was written? Yeah.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. Welcome to the program. You are invited to be a part of it and bring up whatever happens to be on your mind here tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio, you've got me, Ian.
Danica.
And Daryl.
And also coming up here tonight, Daryl, you've got a story about a man who has allegedly been in meditation, in a state of very, very deep meditation for 200 years.
Yes.
Science says he's a mummy, but the Dalai Lama says differently, from what I understand.
Yes.
We'll talk more about that here. Also on the way, $755 condom packs in Venezuela, as well as hand angel. And more. Your thoughts, of course, are certainly welcome. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Plus, Danica is going to report on the Pope, who says that spanking is totally fine so long as the children are, what was it, respected or something like that?
That they get to keep their dignity.
They keep their dignity. All right. So those are all topics that are possibilities here tonight. Of course, your calls and thoughts are welcome. You can also join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. So let's talk about this meditation story because it's just so, it sounds so shocking. I thought it was a joke when you first read the headline to me. This isn't an Onion piece.
No, this is from UPI.
Okay.
So the story posted yesterday says a mummified monk found in Mongolia sitting in the lotus position is not dead, but in a deep meditative trance, according to Buddhist officials. Forensic examinations of the mummified remains are underway at the National Center of Forensics Expertise at Ulaanbaatar, Mongolia, which is the Mongolian capital. Initial examinations determine the mummy to be about 200 years old. The remains were found January 27th, wrapped in cattle skins in the Songinkorkan province of Mongolia.
So they, this guy wasn't sitting in some sort of a Buddhist, what do they call it? What do they call places where they, temple, I guess? Like, he wasn't just sitting there in some place out in the open. They found him somewhere?
He was in a cave. That gets,
okay. Yeah. You
know, he was in a monk cave.
Revealed later down in,
gotcha.
Could have been the monk cave. I'm not sure. Dr. Barry Curzon, who is a Buddhist monk and a physician to the Dalai Lama, said the mummy was in a rare state of meditation called tukdam, which he said is the highest state close to the state of Buddha.
Wow, that's funny because I was actually just reading a book literally today that used that particular term. I'd never heard it before.
Wow. Imagine that.
Curzon adds, if the person is able to remain in this state for more than 3 weeks, which rarely happens, the body gradually shrinks. In the end... all that remains from the person is hair, nails, and clothes. Adding, if the meditator can continue to stay in this meditative state, he becomes a Buddha. A professor at the Mongolian Institute of Buddhist Art, whose name I will not even attempt to pronounce because I know I will pronounce it wrong, said the pose the mummy is in symbolizes the preaching sutra. This is a sign that the Lama is not dead, but in a very deep meditative state, according to ancient tradition of Buddhist Lamas. Police found the remains after discovering that a 45-year-old man, identified as Intor, allegedly stole the mummy from a cave and planned to sell it on the black market. There are claims that the remains are of the teacher Lama Dashi Dorzo Itigilov.
Oh, so you want to pronounce that name, but not the previous one. I see how it is.
The other one has way too many syllables that I know I'm going to wind up goofing up.
Oh, come on. Live a little.
The Lama told his students he was going to die in 1927 and ordered them to exhume his body in 30 years. When he was then unearthed, it is said his body was sitting well-preserved in the lotus position. He was reburied afterwards until 2002, where his body was found still well-preserved.
Well, do you believe this one? I mean, is this legit? Is he actually still alive?
I believe the news story that somebody found a mummy sitting in a lotus position in a cave, but this guy's not meditating. This guy's dead.
My question is, how in the world did he stay in that position instead of just, you know, falling over
crumpling down,
like curling up or being stretched out naturally or
maybe
something?
Maybe because he's really meditating.
Oh, really maybe. I mean, have we been able to feel a pulse or, you know, get this guy a cheeseburger or something?
Well, if you're in a really deep state of meditation, you will not be able to feel a pulse.
Yeah. So the idea, I mean, look, I'm at best a novice when it comes to meditation. I've tried
Same
this
here.
A few times. I've tried it a number of times. Certainly did so in jail more so than any other time. But it is something that I think is a valuable exercise. The idea, as I understand it, and again, I'm not well-versed in it, but the idea is to sort of disconnect yourself from yourself, if you will, and be more at one with everything.
And this guy's definitely disconnected from himself.
And have all of the layers that make you you and make you unique sort of fall away. Have no thoughts coming while this is happening. That's the biggest challenge for somebody who's new to meditation generally, is that your mind will shoot thoughts in, you know, constantly, and it can be very, very difficult.
Yeah, I've got this task to do, or this has to get it, and why am I sitting here and doing absolutely nothing?
Right, or all kinds of things about what happened during the day or what's going to happen tomorrow. I mean, there's always thoughts that come in, and it's quieting the mind that is really the big first step. But, you know, beyond that, I've read things about Buddhist meditation, and I mean, the ideal would be to reach that state of enlightenment, the nirvana state, which Buddha ostensibly reached. And I don't know if it took him 200 years to reach that. I don't know what the time frame was in the Buddha story as far as how long it took him to reach that state. And the experts from the Buddhist group in this story are saying that he has not yet gotten there, that he's still working on it here.
He's close, is what they're saying.
So here's,
but it's one of those things of how do you know when someone else has reached the state of enlightenment? Like, what? I can't tell you that you are knowledgeable about something. You have to determine that for yourself.
Well, I imagine you would just have to go to a monastery and be a mentor under somebody. You know, and looking at this picture, this monk has these robes. These robes look to be, in from the pictures, really good condition. You know, I'm wondering, were these robes found with him, or were they
were wearing them, or was wrapped
on,
right?
Were they added on later?
It says that he was wrapped in cattle skins.
Well, maybe they were. Maybe he was wrapped in those by the guy who stole him. Because wasn't there something
possibly
about someone stealing
him? He was removed from the cave in 2012.
I mean, if you were going to carry a mummy around with you, you might want to have it wrapped before. You know, that way people didn't think weird things. Perhaps.
Sure.
I don't know. I'd be curious why somebody's carrying around somebody in a lotus position.
That's what I mean. That's why you would wrap it that way. It would look maybe like a statue or something that you were carrying around rather than an actual mummy that you were walking about with. I don't know. It's just I'm speculating here.
I don't know. But my point is, you know, this expert guy that says he's close to being a Buddha, there's no way the expert knows if this other person has attained that level, because you only know for yourself what level you have attained.
That's correct. I mean, there's certainly as I understand the story of Buddha, you know, after he achieved enlightenment and faced down Mara and all of that, he returned to walking about. Or
can
was
you tell me who Mara is?
About. It's kind of like the temptation or the devil in some ways. I mean, that's a very basic
like
answer
worldly
to your question.
Lust, really, because.
Kind of.
From what I understand, Buddhism is not really, it's not really a religion, it's a lifestyle, so Mara, I guess, would be...
It depends who you ask.
Yeah, Mara, I guess, would be the equivalent, maybe, like, pointless wants or just things that aren't really
definitely
necessary.
Definitely distracting. Gotcha. Mara comes along and tries to distract him from achieving enlightenment, essentially, with different things. And he did, walk about, from what I understand, quite a bit after that, and people could tell... You know, from what I've read, the people he came across could tell by the way he carried himself, by the things that he said, that he had that state of enlightenment. But again, how do you tell with a mummy who's not talking?
Right.
It's interesting. 855-450-FREE. Do you believe it? Are you Buddhist? What are your thoughts? 855-450-FREE. You can take control here and bring up whatever you want. It's Free Talk Live.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw of free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states, "It's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel." Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
Free Talk Live, the show where anyone can call about whatever they want. And we do mean anyone.
If you're doing something very interesting, or you have a reputation for doing something very interesting,
yeah,
then you become more interesting to track.
I love how dramatic you are. Then you become...
Oh, my. Yeah. Well, once I worked in psychotropic substances when I was working for the CIA.
Yeah. So you were testing, what, LSD or that sort of thing, or what?
Hey, you think I'm going to stay on the air?
You've already told us you work for the CIA.
You couldn't possibly find out who I am.
The way that you speak and your tone of voice, you sound like Cruella DeVille. I've noticed it from the moment you got on the phone.
I even look like her.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You're invited here to take control of the airwaves at 855-450-FREE. We've also got Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm, so feel free to reach out to us that way if you've got that as an option. If you don't yet have that as an option and you like the idea of calling this show, well, you should probably take the time to install it. You'll sound better, and if you sound better, we might be more likely to keep you on for a little bit longer because sometimes some people's phone connections are just absolutely atrocious. So go grab Skype and connect to username lrn.fm. So you can join us online, of course, at freetalklive.com. Coming up, we actually started the show with a strange story out of Mongolia about a Buddhist monk who was in a cave. I guess he wasn't originally in the cave. He was stolen by someone and placed in the cave. I kind of lost track of how.
He was stolen from the cave was taken from the cave in 2012. The story doesn't really say where he was taken from then.
But then recovered.
Then he was stolen, and somebody was trying to sell the monk on the black market. This person was arrested. The monk was recovered. And Buddhist officials are saying that the mummy is not really a mummy. It's a man that is in a deep meditative state.
So we can talk more about that, or you can bring up whatever you want. Plus, there's a story actually out of Taiwan about, and we're going to have to be careful when we talk about this one because we're on broadcast radio. I guess we can probably say
hand job. I don't think that's particularly explicit.
Handies.
Handies. There are men, apparently, who are giving volunteers, or they are volunteers, and they are giving people who are severely disabled manual pleasure. Let's just say that. We can talk more about it. It's a very, very unusual story, and so that's all on the way here. Something else that can be on the way to your home, the home of your loved ones, this Valentine's Day, is Sherry's Berries. It's an amazing product. We've been talking about Sherry's Berries for, I think, a couple years now here on Free Talk Live, off and on, during different holidays, because it's an awesome gift. And starting at just $19.99, you can get some giant, freshly dipped strawberries from Sherry's Berries. It's over 40% savings. All you have to do is go to berries.com. That's berries.com. Click on the microphone and type in this code, FTL. That gets you the deals, and the deals include doubling those berries for just $10 more, which I highly recommend you do that. These are delicious berries dipped in white milk and dark chocolatey goodness, plus topped with chocolate chips, decorative swizzle, or nuts. They are great, and you won't be disappointed, nor will whoever it is you're buying these for, even if that is yourself, because they're really, really tasty. Very good quality, gourmet quality foods. Berries.com. And for some reason, if the person you are ordering for this Valentine's Day doesn't like strawberries, then they've got other treats and goodies like chocolate-covered pretzels and cake pops over at berries.com. So go and check out the whole selection by using code FTL, berries.com.
What's your favorite berry?
It's a tie. I really like the white chocolate ones, but I also really like the dark chocolate ones with the chocolate chips all over them.
See, I'm just not a fan of dark chocolate.
Okay. Oh,
I prefer the white chocolate.
Dark chocolate's the best. What's wrong with you?
I would say it's a toss-up between those two. I mean, the milk chocolate's fine. I don't want to give that any short shrift. But I like the texture of having the chocolate chips all on the outside as well. I think that's nice.
Quit teasing me, you two.
You're going to get some. There's another order on the way. We had some come in earlier this week, but they've been sitting for a few days. And I wanted to make sure you had the proper experience.
Have to go and talk to that Mark person.
B-E-R-R-I-E-S, code F-T-L. So, Daryl, this mummy... And that's what science is saying. Science is saying this guy's a mummy. He's dead. He's been dead for over 100 years.
Right. They're saying that the mummy is about 200 years old.
And so that would mean he's been dead for 200 years.
Not necessarily, because the story also said that he told his followers that he would die in 1927.
I see.
Have they done any sort of, like, testing to make sure that he actually did die in 1927?
I don't think they're going to wind up cutting him apart, because Buddhist officials are saying he's still alive. You don't get to just, like, you know, cut people apart and count their rings.
So I think it's interesting. I mean, I don't know. Obviously, a lot of people are going to be skeptical of this, and I'm certainly skeptical of it. But at the same time, I do understand the point of meditation is to sort of take away all of the aspects of yourself from you and achieve enlightenment. And the Buddhist officials are saying that he's near to that. He's in the state just before enlightenment.
Right.
Presumably he's been there for a few hundred years. For him,
for a while.
I mean, again, I'm not saying that there's any consciousness in this being. It's hard to really even understand what that state is like, right? When you've stripped away all of your individuality and there's just some sort of raw consciousness that remains.
Sure.
You know, this the state of nirvana or enlightenment. And I'm sure there's probably some Buddhist listeners out there saying, oh, you're getting it wrong. Well, please feel free to call in and, you know, clarify. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. But ultimately, you pointed out, Daryl, that if one does achieve a real state of meditation, a deep state of meditation, that things like pulse will be lessened or even non-existent?
Yes, that's what I've heard. And I recall reading a story a couple of months ago from, I think it was India, where there was a man that there was some sort of court case over whether or not he was actually dead or meditating. Mm. And this is fairly recent, and I will try to find the story. so that I, you know, can make sure that I get the facts right. I don't want to wind up being Brian Williams and, you know, misremembering, okay. Which is basically, you know, code for lying to you.
Daryl, you have had concussions, so.
Right, I have. So, you know, I do have, you know, this short-term memory problem occasionally. But there was this court case over whether or not the guy was actually alive or meditating because there wasn't a pulse. There have been other stories of people that have meditated for like 3 days. A family member thought they were dead, and then they take them to the morgue and they wake up. Wow. Wait, I wasn't dead. I was meditating.
Yeah, I've definitely heard of people who have the ability to control their heart rate, right? Like just by concentrating, they can lower the rate of their heart.
I've heard of that too.
And presumably,
and it's just so foreign to us that we just think, oh, you know, what sorcery is this?
Well, I think there's a lot that really in our daily, distracted, busy lives that we don't think that we can accomplish because we're not used to these ideas.
Yeah, definitely.
That human beings are able to do a lot of really amazing things. It's just that we're all so busy with our own little worlds that many of us don't explore those realms, so to speak. And if you've had any experience with it, you're certainly welcome to share that with us toll free at 855-450-FREE.
And apparently it's not just Buddhist, but Hindus also do this deep meditation.
Sure.
I pulled up the story here from The Telegraph about the guy in India where the court was asked whether or not the Hindu guru was dead or meditating.
We can talk about that too. Our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You know, people like that have been able to concentrate and walk around naked easily in snowy conditions. I mean, that's an amazing level of concentration. There's more coming up here in moments. It's Free Talk Live.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug-out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
We've been patiently waiting. Waiting while you tried to ignore us. Waiting while you acted like we didn't exist. Waiting for our chance to be taken seriously. The wait is over. GCN is available 24/7 at GCNlive.com. Navigate through news from your favorite hosts and download archives of past shows. Download the app on your smartphone or tablet or visit GCNlive.com for instant access and live streaming. GCNlive.com, the future of talk radio. Now at your fingertips.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, Buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. 3. Give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
If you are successful at what you do, whether you're a doctor, a lawyer, a business owner, or you have a great career, you understand the concept of protecting yourself. Well, are you protecting yourself, your family, and your assets with quality term life insurance? Consider these possible rates. A man age 45, non-tobacco user, could obtain $1 million of coverage for as little as $75 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 10 years. We specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. A man age 50, non-tobacco user, may be able to obtain $500,000 of coverage for as little as $115 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 20 years. We have great rates for smokers, too. Call the Term Lifeline now. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can dial toll-free and bring up whatever you'd like. 855-450-FREE. Maybe you are a Buddhist or a Buddhist meditation master, or at least you're trying to achieve mastery. Apparently, that's what one monk is still trying to achieve after 200 years of alleged meditation. That's according to some Buddhist experts in Mongolia. After a 200-year-old, what science is saying, mummy has been taken out of a cave, wrapped in a cloth, the Buddhist experts are saying he's not dead. He's meditating. And it's not the first time a story like this has cropped up. Daryl, you've got another related piece. We can get into that. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got also Skype. Skype on in at username lrn.fm. And if you love coffee, you can get a pound of some of the best coffee out there from BuzzBox for free. All you have to do is cover the shipping cost, and it'll be sent right to your door. Again, from BuzzBox Coffee, it's shade-grown, 100% organic, and top 1% grade Arabica. Free Talk Live has teamed up with BuzzBox to provide you with some killer coffee, but also to help people out around the world in difficult parts of the world in which to live by providing them with microloans to help change their lives for the better by offering those folks an opportunity to make their own lives better through, you know, using those loans to perhaps buy some new equipment for their business or start a business in the first place. And we've been doing that. For every 10 listeners that signs up at coffee.freetalklive.com, we can fund one new microloan every month, from what I understand. You can go and get signed up over at coffee.freetalklive.com. Your first pound's free, then you're on the auto ship program, which you can cancel anytime. But once you get your first pound, you can then customize how often you'd like to get shipments and what size the shipment should be and the flavor and all that. So coffee.freetalklive.com. I did look up a little bit about Mara just to tell you more, Danica, since you'd asked about it. When you read the story of Buddha, Mara is one of the more central, I guess, characters in the story. And it's while Buddha is attempting to achieve enlightenment, Mara attempts or tries to tempt the Buddha by seducing him with the vision of beautiful women who in various legends are often said to be Mara's daughters. Mara's considered to be a demon. In Buddhist cosmology, Mara personifies unwholesome impulses, unskillfulness, the death of spiritual life. He is a tempter, distracting humans from practicing the spiritual life by making mundane things alluring. So you're pretty much on target there.
Gotcha.
Or the negative seemed to be positive. The word Mara comes from the Proto-Indo-European root mer, meaning to die. The Sanskrit form of the verbal root. Anyway, it takes a... Well, they could get a little too Englishy there. But interesting stuff. There's more to learn about that if you care to. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So, Daryl, you've got a story out of India where Hindu is also a religion in which meditation is fairly popular.
Yes.
And there was a similar story where a court was trying to determine whether or not a man was dead or just meditating.
That's correct. The story actually is from May of last year, so it's a little older than I thought. from The Telegraph. They write, the family and followers of one of India's wealthiest Hindu spiritual leaders are fighting a legal battle over whether he is dead or simply in a deep state of meditation. His Holiness Sri Ashutosh Maharaj, the founder of a religious order that I'm not going to try to pronounce, with a property estate of approximately $170 million U.S. dollars, according to his wife and son, died in January of last year. However, his disciples have refused to let the family take his body for cremation because they claim he is still alive. According to his followers based in the Punjab city of Jalandhar, he simply went into a deep samadhi or meditation, and they have frozen his body to preserve it for when he wakes up. His body is currently contained in a commercial freezer.
Wow.
And so the High Court of Punjab, was asked to decide whether or not he was alive or dead. If he was dead, then the family would get the body to cremate. And again, this was from May of last year. I found an update from December that said that the court stayed a ruling that he was legally dead and could be cremated. His body will remain frozen until at least February 9th of this year. So it's still going to be a few days until they wind up, you know, possibly removing his body from the freezer, I think, to be cremated. I'm not really sure what they're actually going to wind up doing with the yogi, I think is the term that they use. Okay. No, guru. Not yogi, guru. So the story from another website says that he died January 29th of last year of a heart attack. Physicians and police confirmed his death, but his followers say that he was in a transcendental meditative state. And, you know, then it goes in to talk a little bit about the court case that happened.
And it was his followers who put him in the ice.
They put him in the freezer to preserve him for when he woke up from the deep meditative state.
But some family members believe he's dead and would like to cremate him. Is that right?
All of the family members that they talk about, which is the wife and children, they say he's dead.
How old? I'm sorry if I missed this.
70-something years old.
Okay, so he's not like a 70s. Young man. Okay.
Right.
And he went into a state of meditation. That was his intention, right?
That's what the followers say.
Yeah.
The family says he had a heart attack and died. And
I see.
Physicians and other medical people say he had a heart attack and died.
Wow.
But I'm not really sure exactly what the court ruled because I can't really navigate the Indian court's website.
No, it's a tough, it's really an interesting question because, I mean, presumably this guy, he was this leader in this group.
Mm-hmm.
And he, I guess, intended to begin meditating and then presumably died during that meditation. Again, if you believe the followers, right? That they think he's still meditating, but I guess, you know, nobody really knows within the family what he was really doing. Their argument would be that, well, we're his family, so we should be able to decide. But if he had devoted his life to this belief system and, you know, meditating and things like that, then shouldn't that choice be respected? I mean, he doesn't essentially, you know, there's no will here necessarily.
Right.
Right.
So how do you decide in this case whose wishes should be honored?
That's a very good question.
What do you think?
Well, I mean, obviously it should probably be to the individual. I mean, didn't the individual have something saying, it may appear that I could be like I'm dead, but I'm not. So this, you know, if I don't wake up for my meditation, the worst case scenario, this is what I want done.
The articles don't mention anything about
instructions,
will, living will, some sort of instructions of, if you think I'm dead,
I think if he had prepared something like that, it would have saved a lot of trouble.
Possibly.
I may be wrong, but.
Possibly. I forget the specifics, but my aunt, who was married to a Native American,
he had a will specifying that after he died, he wanted one thing to happen. I forget if it was cremation or to be buried, but Cheyenne tradition was to do the other thing. And some of his family sued to basically overturn his will. And I forget the exact outcome of the court case, but even when you have a will, that doesn't necessarily mean that, you know, what you want is going to happen.
Yeah, that's really sad. Hey, this is what I want after I'm dead. And oh, look at that. I can't have it happen after all.
Can one do a radio will?
A radio will?
You know, that's a good question.
If I say, you know, something on the radio that I want to happen after I'm dead, is that legally binding?
I couldn't tell you. I'm not a lawyer. I can't tell you what's legally binding or not. I imagine there's some specific rules to what wills should say. I'm sure LegalZoom.com can help you figure all that stuff out, but I don't know. I mean, certainly you could leave a set of instructions. And
if I'm near the ocean, throw me in there so a shark eats me?
One could argue that if that's the only set of instructions you've left, that that is your will and it should be respected.
Is that your full body or your ashes?
If I'm near a cave, throw me in there, let a bear eat me?
So throw in the full body is what you're saying.
Full
just
body.
Toss you in the ocean. All right, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. This is Free Talk Live.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates. 1-800-425-4610. Based on actual cases, results may vary. Not a solicitation for legal services.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Listen Lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. Dial on in toll-free here and bring up what you'd like. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Coming up, a bizarre story from Vice Magazine about volunteers who are digitally manipulating the genitals of those who are severely disabled.
Oh, that was a good one.
Clinical way to talk about what's going on here without being too, pandering. We don't want to pander. The FCC doesn't like that. So we can talk about that. That's still on the way here tonight. Plus, Danica, the Pope, you're going to tell us, has spoken out about spanking. And he says it's A-OK. But there's one provision. We'll tell you more about that.
Absolutely.
In a little bit.
As long as you remember the safe word.
855-450-FREE. We're talking about spanking your kids. 855-450-3733.
Daryl, that's gross.
So we were just talking about the story out of Mongolia and then another one out of India involving people of both the Buddhist and Hindu religions. If, again, it's not really fair to call Buddhism a religion.
Faith?
No, it's not really. I don't think faith is really.
It's more of a lifestyle, really.
Yeah, that's probably more accurate. Although there are certain sects of Buddhism that it has become a religion and Buddha has sort of become a prophet or a god or whatever you want to use that term.
I think faith would be a good compromise for a term.
I would love to know what a Buddhist would say, how they would define how different Buddhism is from religion. More of a path, I think, than it is faith. I mean, it's something they're trying to attain here and now. Anyway, so share your thoughts with us here. I mean, the three of us are not Buddhists. Is that correct?
Okay. That's correct.
I've done some reading about it. I've read about meditation. I've tried some meditation. I'm a total novice when it comes to this stuff. So I am fascinated by it, and I'm certainly fascinated by what masters of meditation are able to achieve. I mean, we were talking earlier about how humans have been able to do some pretty amazing stuff, you know, just by focusing, lowering their heart rate, or, Daryl, as you've said, in serious meditative states, having no detectable heart rate, but yet still being
alive. Right, so if your heart rate is like, you know, 3 beats per minute, that's not detectable.
Is that right? Okay. I'm not a doctor, so I'll take your word for it.
Yeah, most people, normal heart rate is, you know, like a beat a second.
Okay.
So if you put your, you know, 2 fingers over their artery on the wrist or on their neck, you're going to feel something. If it's, you know, 1 beat every 15 seconds,
yeah, you're not
going to
notice.
You're not going to notice unless you keep your fingers there so long, and then you're going to be like, wait, what was that anomaly?
So anyway, I just think it's fascinating. And, you know, you can look at other things that people have been able to do in the past. For instance, the Quran, that is, of course, the Muslim holy book that was memorized originally. It was actually a vocal tradition. The entirety of the Quran was memorized by the followers of the Quran. And if you could just imagine, you know, I was talking about how we're so busy with our lives today and our technology and distracted. It's not that we're any different human beings than those human beings were, you know, so many years ago. It's just that we don't believe we can remember that level of text. Can you imagine?
Now, was the Quran memorized because they didn't have the ability to write or didn't know how to write then?
That's
or
probably mostly the
because
case.
The Greeks did the same with their, you know, with their mythology and their stories.
Right, but no, the Quran came well after the development of written language. It was well after Christianity.
So it was purposely
and
not
the written text of Christianity.
But that doesn't mean that everyone was literate in, enough to
right,
be
but
able
there
to
were
write
scribes that,
that
could have written.
Yeah, that's
is
true.
What I'm saying.
That's true.
So you know the ability to write it down
it was there.
There.
It was there. How
so
widely...
it was there. They purposely chose not to write it down and memorize it.
I don't remember.
For feet.
Yeah, and I don't remember for how many years it was a vocal tradition.
Gotcha.
I don't remember when the first written copy came into existence. But certainly now we rely so much on our technology. You know, I got my calendar programs that tell me when I need to do things, and if I need to remember stuff, I write them down on a to-do list. But when I hear about people being able to memorize the entirety of what is not a short book, the Quran is a lengthy book.
Mm-hmm.
To the idea of memorizing that level of text is so daunting, and to word for word memorize this. This is what they were taught by age 6, from what I've read.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so I was just thinking about that and realizing that, you know, we're not different than they are. We're still the same human beings. It's just that we don't focus our energies in those same areas, and so we don't develop that ability.
Right, and I don't know for certain because, you know, Albert Einstein isn't here for me to ask, but I've heard that Einstein did not ever remember his telephone number because he thought that that was something menial.
Unimportant.
And unimportant.
Yep.
He, you know, used his brain to remember other things, like,
sure,
you know, how to, you know, figure out the theory of relativity.
Totally believable. I mean, same thing with me. When I get a new cell phone number, I don't really know what it is for a long time, usually.
That's why I've kept the same cell phone number for, yeah, like 8 years.
Same here.
So you can share your thoughts on whether it's meditation or the idea of what other things are humans capable of doing that we're just not regularly doing simply because our focus is elsewhere. What other, you know, abilities are we missing out on? Could we benefit from? I mean, in order to get to the level of mastery in meditation that these guys have, it takes a lifetime. I mean, it takes a long time to really be able to get there. And if you're always flitting about here, hither and thither, and, you know, trying to get your to-do list taken care of, you're never going to become a master of meditation. You would have to spend your life focusing on that. That's not to say you shouldn't try it. That's not to say that there's not value in learning to meditate. I truly believe that there is. So, toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Something else there's value in is self-pleasure. But unfortunately for some people who are severely disabled, well, they just can't, simply because they're physically unable to manipulate themselves. Stories over at Vice.com. Andy is a muscular dystrophy patient who lives with his parents in southern Taiwan. Due to his severe physical disability, he was homeschooled and could not leave his house alone, so he never really had the opportunity to develop in either an active social life or a romantic relationship.
So he's been paralyzed since he was born, is that correct?
It's not real clear, but
oh,
it sounds
okay.
Like since early on.
Since he was young, okay.
When Taiwanese non-governmental organization Hand Angel, their website is handjobtw.org, an organization promoting the sexual rights of disabled people, first spoke to Andy, they realized that his situation meant he'd also never been able to have a frank conversation with anyone about his sexuality. And as a young gay man who didn't want to speak to his parents about his feelings, this wasn't exactly the healthiest situation to be in. I mean, it's hard to really even imagine the difficulty that could cause somebody to never have had the ability to be intimate in any meaningful way with anyone at any point in their life. And certainly to be living in a society in which, you know, sex is present. And I don't know what it's like in Taiwan, obviously. Certainly it's different in Europe versus in the United States. And I think they comment on that here in a little bit in the story. But to live in a world where lots of people are having sex with one another, and you might like to, but you just don't have the opportunity, period. There's just no way for you to do it. You can't even leave your house. And, of course, there are one solution someone would say would be prostitution to that. And, of course, prostitution is illegal in a lot of places. But if you don't get paid for the sex act, then it's not illegal, right?
Yeah.
Right.
If you're just voluntarily going and providing sexual pleasure to an individual, that's not prostitution.
Are they being paid by another person or organization for doing
They are that? Volunteers.
They're
generally,
just volunteers.
The term
okay.
volunteer doesn't include getting pay. I suppose that, you know, they might have like a stipend
or something. Yeah.
Maybe the group gives them the...
Oh, goodness.
Maybe the group gives them, you know, a gas stipend to get there or something like that.
Sure.
So more from the story here. Over the course of a few months, representatives from Hand Angel counseled Andy online, helping him to understand his own sexuality and place in the world. Next, they smuggled him out of his house and took him to a motel for a hand job. Taiwan, officially known as the Republic of China, has one of the best health systems in the world, according to Vice. Its million or so disabled citizens receive some of the most thorough medical attention you'll find, including everything from long-term care to traditional herbal medicine. What they don't receive from this system, however, is any kind of aid when it comes to slightly more intimate issues, namely orgasms. There's more to say about this story. We'll continue it here in moments. 855-450-FREE. Daryl's got a big smile on his face.
I don't even want to know.
We'll find out what that's all about here in a moment. And your calls and thoughts are certainly welcome. I don't know if I agree that someone has a right to sex. I mean, that's sort of what they insinuate in the first paragraph. We can dig in deeper here. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, February 6th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.09 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,250 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $219. Antiwar.com reports, fresh from his latest NATO meeting, Secretary of Defense Chuck Hagel warned that there is a growing division within the alliance along a north-south axis. Hagel saw the problem as twofold and seemed to blame southern member nations on both counts, saying the North wants to focus on the growing threat from Russia, while the southern nations are worried about North Africa. There's a big, obvious division, but Hagel also saw a problem in that many of the nations with less gargantuan military adversaries believed the alliance can only handle a war with one or the other, while Hegel assured it was a time for unity and heavy military investment so NATO could fight a whole bunch of conflicts at once. Ultimately, this split reflects the reality that NATO hasn't had a unified threat since the Cold War ended, and keeping the alliance around for the sake of hostility towards whoever the US is riled up against at any given time is making less and less sense. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports electronics retailer Radio Shack filed for bankruptcy protection on Thursday and said it had a deal in place to sell as many as 2,400 stores to an affiliate of hedge fund Standard General, its lender and largest shareholder. Under an agreement, wireless company Sprint would operate as many as 1,750 of those stores. Radio Shack's bankruptcy, which has been expected for months, follows 11 consecutive unprofitable quarters as the company has failed to transform itself into a destination for mobile phone buyers. But its sales agreement with Standard General could spare it the fate of most retailers suffering Chapter 11 liquidation. Radio Shack said in a statement that the Standard General affiliate, called General Wireless, would acquire between 1,500 and 2,400 of its 4,100 stores. Sprint would occupy about one-third of each Radio Shack store, selling mobile devices across Sprint's brand portfolio, as well as Radio Shack products, services, and accessories. Other potential buyers will also have the opportunity to bid on Radio Shack assets. Any deal will need to be approved by the bankruptcy court in Delaware. You can support FPP Radio by shopping online. Whether you're looking for precious metals, bitcoins, or books, you'll find that and more at shop.fppradio.com. Every purchase you make from one of my affiliates at shop.fppradio.com helps fund FPP Radio. That's shop.fppradio.com. UPI reports the U.S. Supreme Court granted a stay Thursday to a man who was scheduled to die next week after 30 years on death row in Texas. Lawyers for Lester Leroy Bauer have appealed his conviction and sentence to the highest court. Their grounds include the length of time since he was given a death sentence, and they argue that a 30-year wait for execution is cruel and unusual punishment. Bauer has continued to deny that he killed Bobby Tate, Philip Good, Ronald Mays, and Jerry Brown in an aircraft hangar in 1983 during an attempt to hijack an ultralight plane. His lawyers say there is significant lingering doubt regarding guilt or innocence. The Supreme Court has not yet decided whether to review the case. The justices agreed automatically to delay the execution, but said it will expire if they decide not to take the appeal. Since he was convicted in 1984, Bauer has had six execution dates. His lawyer said, by any standard, the length of Bauer's incarceration on death row is unusual and far outside anything the framers of the Constitution would have considered acceptable rather than cruel. The lawyers also argue that Texas procedures in death penalty cases in 1984 may have prevented the jury from hearing testimony of Bauer's good character that might have mitigated evidence in the sentencing phase, and that prosecutors may have failed to produce evidence that contradicted their theory that Bowers was guilty. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
My fellow sheep, election season is upon us. Are you one of the 12% of Americans who still approves of our government? Then we need your help to force the other 88% into compliance. Our democracy depends on it. We're an organization called Citizens Against Too Much Unfettered Freedom, or CATMUF. CATMUF is a bipartisan flock of sheep whose goal is expanding government until nothing else remains. Because the government is here to help you. How can you help CATMUF help you? By only voting for candidates dedicated to expanding government. It's easy. You don't need to study the issues. No matter what a politician says when running for office, they're all dedicated to expanding government. And make sure you tell all your friends and family to vote for more government. Here at CATMUF, we don't care if you vote Democrat or Republican, as long as you vote for candidates committed to growing our federal family. CATMUF,
because folks just aren't smart enough to handle real freedom.
We are back with more Free Talk Live, inviting you to become part of the program. You can bring up anything that you'd like to discuss. We talked about a Buddhist monk who the Buddhists claim is still meditating after 200 years. Science is saying he's dead, Jim. So you can share your thoughts on...
I don't think the Buddhist guy's name was Jim.
That's true. Well, they would be... Saying he's dead, Jim, would be talking to someone named Jim, not talking about the Buddhist.
I thought you were quoting something from Star Trek.
That's what it was, yes.
Yes!
So you can talk about that if you'd like. Also, you can join us on any topic that you might. Our toll-free number, again, is 855-450-FREE. We were just telling you, if you're just tuning in, we were just telling you about Hand Angel. This is a non-governmental organization based in Taiwan who provides sexual services for free. They provide digital manipulation of one's genitals for very disabled, severely disabled individuals. One young gentleman who has been disabled throughout his entire life, it seems, was unable to leave his home, for instance, when he was growing up. And I think that's still like the case today. The folks from Hand Angel came to his home and they smuggled him out of his house and took him to a motel to give him a hand job. According to the story here at Vice.com, it was for this reason that a group of social campaigners and volunteers took it upon themselves. This is the reason, I'm sorry, is that the health system in Taiwan doesn't take care of people's sexual needs. They are taking care of them in a lot of other ways, but Hand Angel decided that they needed a little bit more. And so that's the main service. They provide hand jobs to the severely disabled. Members say their work raises awareness of the fact that disabled people are often depicted as desexualized, as well as having their sexuality constantly neglected, despite the fact they share the same desires as anybody else. And that makes sense. Just because you've been crippled your entire life doesn't mean that you wouldn't have the same sexual proclivities.
Okay, so this starts running a lot of questions through my mind.
Okay.
And I actually had similar thoughts back when the whole Patient Protection Affordable Care Act thing was being shoved through Congress. I call it by its actual name. Most people know it as Obamacare. The thing that basically says everybody has to purchase health insurance. If you can't afford it, then you can get this government program because health care is a right. And we will provide you health care for free. If you can't afford it, blah, 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 you know, jump through a hoop and a hurdle. Something that I thought at the time is sexual health is part of total health.
Okay.
So will people that are, you know, maybe a little kind of awkward and not really good at picking up women at a bar or getting a girlfriend, will the government then send hookers to their house to take care of their sexual needs to keep them, you know, all there mentally? And I realized that, you know, in Taiwan, they're only helping out the people that are crippled. But what about the other people that might have problems?
What about lonely people?
Yeah, people that are, you know, severely lonely.
Well, they're starting to have those snuggle cafes, you know, where they go and they snuggle with someone.
Right, but that's not being covered by health insurance.
They have that. It could be
considered covered by health insurance because
they have snuggle cafes now?
Well, yes, it's like a cafe, like you go and you cuddle someone, you get drinks, them non-alcoholic, but just...
This is new, because I'd heard about the snuggle houses or whatever, where mm-hmm. you go and you pay basically the same price that you might pay a prostitute for snuggling.
Right.
I'd never heard of a cafe environment where you, like, sit down for a cup of coffee or something?
Purchase like a drink with you when you, like, before or after cuddling.
You can purchase a drink with the snuggler?
In some places, yes. I've heard of some places being able to sell drinks to just, you know, maybe, you know, help break the ice. And they're typically not alcoholic, you know, because they have to have a license to do that. But
yeah, so a cup of coffee.
You know, snuggle cafes, snuggle houses. So, I mean, you know, the snuggle part is totally therapeutic. I mean, I can see someone saying, hey, this should get covered by my health insurance because I'm, you know, feeling better now that I have physical contact with someone.
Yeah. Right. So, you know, like, how far does this go and where do you sort of stop it?
Well, I mean, if it's voluntary, then it can go as far as it wants
right,
to go.
Right, but I'm saying as far as, you know, like, claiming that it a right, mm-hmm. and that it's to be provided by either an insurance or, you know, some sort of taxpayer subsidized sort of thing.
Yeah, I guess that is a good question. Is, you know, would an insurance company spend its money on this?
They'll spend a lot of money on mental health for people,
right? And arguably, this is about mental health,
right?
Yeah. I don't know. That's a good question, and you are certainly welcome to answer it for us. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've got Tommy. He's in Glasgow, and you can bring up anything as well. Tommy, go ahead with your thoughts tonight.
Yeah, good evening. How you doing? Don't take a live. We'll never take a Free Talk Live.
Welcome,
can you hear me okay? Yes?
Yeah, your connection isn't the best, but go ahead.
Is that any better now?
Just go for it.
Right. Just talking on the issue of the Buddhist guy, and you mentioned the Quran. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was what you would call meditating or maybe even praying to God. The Islamic faith is a continuation of Christianity and Judaism. It follows the Abrahamic line of faiths where the two houses of Judaism and Islam spring from the line of Abraham, who had a yep. child with his wife and his midwife or his maiden. And from Ishmael came the both the Semitic tribes. You know, if you look at them, both Semitic, the Arabs and the Jewish tribes. And the Muslims believe that Jesus was a holy prophet.
That's correct.
And that the enemies of Jesus, they changed his message. For example, the Saul line doctrine, it was a man, you know, the Saul to Damascus guy, that was about 70, 80 years after Jesus. And most of the Christian faith is based on what his teachings were. And then you look back 325 years AD, there was a king, Constantine, and they forged the Trinity, and, you know, the Father, the Son, the Holy Ghost. And this was out with the fold of Christianity at the time, because they were a monotheistic faith, you know, they believed in the one God.
So wait, it was Constantine that proposed the Trinity?
Yeah, and that was 325 years after Jesus walked to earth. And so what happened, and so the Jewish people were waiting for a prophet, and they still are, but they were looking for the same line as them from the Jewish prophets, from the line, you know, from Abraham, Noah, Jesus, and the Muslims all believe that. But then in 70 AD, the temple was destroyed. They were the part of the Wailing Wall you see in Al-Quds, Jerusalem, and the temple was destroyed in the Jewish diaspora. And so in their own Talmud, the Jewish people should not return to the land of where their forefathers came from, Israel, because of what happened to their temple, you know, and they should not return
to the
Messiah.
You're losing me, Tommy. You're losing me. I'm sorry. I'm not well-versed enough.
What I'm getting to is a point of how sorry if we get into a mad tangent. I do apologize about that. But I was trying to give a whole basis of where I'm getting to, because what happened with the message of Jesus, the enemies of him changed what happened in his life. So then what happened, the angel Gabriel who came to Mary for Jesus, the angel Gabriel came to Muhammad when he was meditating in a cave in the outskirts of Mecca, what we know as Mecca. And then what happened was he was told to read in the name of the Lord who created you. And then what happened, Gabriel would visit him.
Sorry, you got cut off there for a moment. Tommy, we lost you for a second. You said what happened, what?
Yeah, so what happened, over a period of Angel Gabriel visited the Prophet Muhammad.
That's
and
right.
He recited to him what was became the Quran.
Correct, and Muhammad could not, Muhammad was essentially, he was illiterate, so he couldn't write
it down. He was known as the unlettered prophet. He could not read nor write.
That's right. This is the story. He had to memorize the messages that he was allegedly receiving from the angel Gabriel. And Tommy, thank you for the call tonight. Appreciate it. And so he was referring to a discussion we were having in the last hour about the sort of oral tradition in the Muslim religion that actually had young people memorizing the entirety of the Quran, which was a long book, memorizing it word for word as basically one of the first things they do when entering into the religion. And I don't think they do that these days. I'm sure there's some people who do it, but it's not as common. 855-450-FREE. You can take control here on Free Talk Live. More hand jobs coming up.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the Free State and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with a chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial on in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Just drop on by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features waiting for you there. Once again, freetalklive.com with you tonight. You've got me, Ian.
Danica.
And Daryl.
ExpressCoin is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies, including Bitcoin, Litecoin, or Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're also a licensed money services business, so they've jumped through those governmental hoops, so you don't have to worry about that stuff. You get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, and you can do it all over at ExpressCoin.com. Whether in the United States or Canada, visit ExpressCoin.com or do it from your smartphone by grabbing their app over at ExpressCoin.com. And don't forget to use coupon code FTL and you'll get up to $40 worth of your favorite cryptocurrency with no fee at all. So again, don't forget code FTL at ExpressCoin.com. Let's go to Dustin. He's listening in North Carolina via TuneIn. Hello, Dustin.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Welcome. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Well, I'm just calling in. I'm the editor of Muslim American Magazine, and I wanted to just correct a couple little things about the memorization of Quran.
Sure.
The first thing I want to say is that there are absolutely lots and lots of people that still memorize the entire Quran around the world.
And, yeah, I suspected that there was a relatively small group. What percentage, though, of Muslims these days are really doing that, though?
I couldn't tell you the percentage, but I can tell you that in North Carolina, in Charlotte, North Carolina, where the local community is, it's a community of about 5,000 to 6,000 people, and we're talking about somewhere in the neighborhood of 300 or 400 people that have memorized the Quran completely.
Wow, that's impressive.
So about 10%.
Yeah, I haven't even memorized a 30th of it yet. I've got all the short chapters, but and it's young kids that are memorizing too. I met a kid that was 8 years old that had memorized the whole thing.
Well, yeah, that's what I was saying before. I mean, from what I've learned about it in the past, this memorization was usually expected to be completed by 6.
I would suspect that the full memorization is probably more. I'm not sure what the correct term, but it happens more often, if you will, in some of the less developed areas of the world. So a lot of the Middle East, Pakistan, Afghanistan, etc. Because here in the U.S., there's just so much technology and other things that are pulling at you that, it's probably not as expected here.
Well, it takes a huge level of dedication to do something like that.
That's true. And I have to tell you that there are actually schools. I'll give you a couple of terms. First of all, anybody that has memorized the entire Quran is called Hafiz. Okay, and the schools where they study that are called Hifz schools. It's a conjugation of the word. But there are probably about a dozen different Hifz schools in the United States where they're teaching kids to memorize the Quran, and they're graduating Hafiz per year. But what you say about the less developed countries or the less industrialized countries, I think it'd probably be a better term, it's absolutely correct, because there's a cultural attachment that we don't quite have carried over in the U.S. And one of the issues that we run into in the U.S. and one of the issues that the imams that I deal with are trying to combat is there is a huge emphasis on memorizing the Quran in Arabic, but not as much emphasis on deconstructing and analyzing the meanings.
Mm-hmm.
And since Quranic Arabic is 1,400 years old, even Arabic-speaking people that memorize the Quran don't really understand 100%.
Yeah, I was going to say, what's the point of memorizing something in a language that makes it less than meaningful?
Well, absolutely. In some respects, it's similar to some of the more old school Catholic churches that still do their mass in Latin.
Mm-hmm.
But I dare say that 99% of the people that are sitting there listening to the mass in Latin have no clue what is being said.
You're right. And that is a huge problem. And that's a problem that we've been addressing in the Muslim community, because we go back to the teachings of Prophet Muhammad, and he specifically told us that when you go into a land and teach the people about Islam that you teach in the language of the land that you're in.
Sure.
So it's, you know, it's, I don't want to make fatwa here, but it's a violation of Islamic principle to teach in a language that people don't understand.
Interesting. You know, Dustin, I appreciate you clearing that up. Was there anything else you wanted to throw out there tonight?
No, I just want to let you guys know that we're that our magazine's out there. We're publishing every month, and I'd invite you all to check it out at MuslimAmerican.com.
MuslimAmerican.com, is that right?
Yes, sir.
Now, are you? How long of a time have you been listening to Free Talk Live?
Oh, gosh, I listen off and on, maybe about 6 months to a year.
So,
I called a couple times before.
Were you listening when we had Will Colley on from Muslims for Liberty?
Yeah,
okay.
And I'm friends with Will Colley. I know the work that he does with Muslims for Liberty.
Cool.
He's actually contributed to our magazine a few times.
Right on. If you didn't know about him, I wanted to make sure you found out about him on this phone call. But
and Davi Barker, the Muslim agorist.
Yep, that's right.
The shiny badges guy.
Yeah.
Hey, Dustin, thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate the clarification. It's always nice, you know, when folks call in to make it clear, because we're just, you know, we're just sitting in here as talk show hosts. We really don't have expertise on a lot of the things we talk about.
You know, it's funny that you say we don't have expertise, but Davi Barker actually just sent me an email.
Uh-huh.
And said that he's not in a place that he could make a telephone call, but he was able to send an email. He said, just wanted to clarify, the Quran was memorized at first because Muhammad and many Arabs at the time were illiterate, so it was recited, memorized, and taught, but it was written down within Muhammad's lifetime.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I said
if a scribe was present, they wrote down as much as was recited during that session. But all the written fragments weren't compiled into a single manuscript until generations later.
Mm.
Also, Quran memorization is common to this day. Davi says that he has memorized 6 of the chapters, his wife has memorized 1/3 of the book, and his brother-in-law has memorized the entire Quran. It's actually easier to memorize than you would think. It has intuitive rhyme schemes and many repeating patterns.
Yeah.
Plus, it's easier for kids because, neurologically speaking, the language centers are stronger when they're young, and many Islamic schools use the Quran to teach grammar and literacy.
Mm. Neat stuff. So thank you for sharing that, Davi Barker from shinybadges.com. Our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. Do you have a right to sexual services? Do you have a right to have someone provide you with an orgasm? Over in Taiwan, there's a non-governmental organization called Hand Angel that is providing free hand jobs.
How often?
Let's talk about that coming up here in a moment. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. In fact, they'll talk about the Netherlands here. Apparently, they actually are in the government paying public money for sexual services for people. And there's a number on that, how often that happens, too. 855-450-FREE. There's more coming up. You can share your thoughts with us. It's Free Talk Live.
This is Holly Thomas, Group Vice President of Cause Marketing for Macy's. Our company is working together with the March of Dimes through March for Babies to raise money and awareness about the serious problem of premature birth in the U.S. That's why Macy's is committed to raising funds through our employees, customers, family, and friends to improve the health of moms and babies everywhere. Won't you please join us in March for Babies? Start a team today at marchforbabies.org.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow. A new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Pushed to the breaking point after constantly being taken to task without ever hearing a word of thanks for what it does around here, an overwhelmed and infuriated nation announced in February that it was trying, okay, Jesus Christ. A poll of the American populace revealed that 33% felt they were doing pretty damn well, thank you, while another 28% just wanted 2 freaking minutes without somebody breathing down their neck.
We're trying as hard as we can here. How about cutting some little slack for a change, huh? You know what? This is just bullshit. I do not need this shit.
Christ Almighty, sources added. God distanced himself from the entire right-wing fundamentalist Christian movement, saying that he did not believe pregnancies result from his divine will. The Almighty Father went on to dismiss capital punishment, gun rights, the anti-abortion movement, and the efforts of the Westboro Baptist Church, while adding that he and Christian conservatives, quote, no longer saw eye to eye on the majority of issues. And physicists discovered that the entirety of our known universe is actually the fictional setting of a cop show called Hard Case.
This is the Onion News Network.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it. Use it. Spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up what you want right here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Drop on by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features waiting for you. That again, freetalklive.com. Another great site is Freedom's Phoenix. They're uncovering the secrets and exposing the lies every day over at freedomsphoenix.com. You are constantly provided the detailed real news that lies between the lines of propaganda and the relationship we have with coercive governments. freedomsphoenix.com offers up-to-the-minute updates on the economy, technology, communications, and the rise of the police state. Go to freedomsphoenix.com. You can get signed up for their free daily dispatch. That again is freedomsphoenix.com. So back to the story from vice.com, which is very unusual. It's something I've never really read about. There are people who are volunteers that are providing hand jobs for the severely disabled. The organization is called Hand Angel. Their website, handjobtw.org.
I wonder if somebody could get community service credit for doing this. If they were ordered by a court, you must do community service.
Yeah, I would, presuming, I mean, I don't know what the rules are in Taiwan, but again, you know, it sounds like it's a nonprofit organization. So I know that here in New Hampshire, any nonprofit registered with the state.
Well, what do you think Judge Burke would say? If some college girl that gets one of these open container things decides, you know what, I'm not paying the fine, I'm going to go to trial, ask for community service, and Judge Burke says you've got to do 12 hours of community service, comes in with this letter from Hand Angels, and said, you know,
it would be legit. I mean, there in
it, totally
at least,
would be.
Yeah, at least in New Hampshire. And again, I don't know about other areas of the world, but as long as you are working for a nonprofit organization registered with the state of New Hampshire, and all it takes to register a nonprofit organization with the state is basically $25 in a short form that's got five signatures on it. I mean, so it's not hard to do that. And so it probably would work.
I'm just curious if the judge would accept it.
I don't see why he wouldn't be able to.
Well, they can say that something is not valid community service.
Yeah, that's true. They could, but as long as you're doing it for a nonprofit, it tends to be accepted from what I've seen. So so that's happening in Taiwan, and there's more about that, but they take a moment in the story at Vice to break away and talk about in the Netherlands, the national health system, that's a government-run healthcare system, provides a grant scheme for people with disabilities to receive public money to pay for sexual services up to 12 times per year.
Wow.
In Taiwan,
sex... So once a month.
Correct. In Taiwan, sex remains a taboo. And some Buddhists, the sovereign state's primary religion, believe that someone suffering from a disability means they're paying for bad deeds in a past life. So not the best mix for those like Andy, unfortunately. He told the author, quote, "I can't tell my parents that I also have sexual desires." Again, this guy is, if you're just tuning in, he is severely disabled, stuck at home, can't move, basically has no sexual life whatsoever, no relationships, has never been on a date. So he says, "I can't tell my parents, and I can't come out of the closet in front of them. My family's care puts a lot of pressure on me and sabotages me from normal romantic relations." Vincent, the 50-year-old founder of Hand Angel, lost his legs to polio and says his disability allows him to better empathize with applicants' needs without any of the patronization that disabled people can sometimes face. He emphasized that, quote, "disabled people share the same physical and emotional needs as any others and therefore should have the right to pursue them." Now, that I agree with. That statement I agree with. So the article used the in the first paragraph, it used the term that second paragraph used the term sexual rights for disabled people. I don't think you have a right to sex, but I do agree with the founder of Hand Angel, who says that you should have the right to pursue your sexual gratification. And that would mean that in a society that would hopefully be more accepting towards sexual services being available for sale, that you would have the right to go and buy sexual services, providing someone was willing to offer them on the marketplace. In the case of Hand Angel, they're doing these services for free, and it sort of seems sort of underground the way that they're going about it due to the sexual prohibitions.
Well, and there might even be some kind of regulation against, you know, doing it under some sort of volunteer organization to where, well, now you're conspiring to do prostitution, but you're doing it for free, but we're still going to say that, you know, because there's basically this...
You're obviously ashamed of what you're doing because you had to be secretive about it.
Well, I mean, they're not secretive to the point where they don't have a website and aren't, you know, being publicized to some extent. So obviously they exist, and the government guys probably know they exist. I think they're secretive about what they do because of society, because the way people will look at sex services being provided,
right, but
in this way.
You know, there's a lot of escort agencies that have websites.
That's true.
But they put right on the website, you know, "you are paying for my time."
Right.
"Anything that happens is between consenting adults." But governments still wind up, you know, going and arresting these girls.
Sure. Well, usually that's when they cross somebody or they don't pay the bribes or whatever. So Vincent says he emphasized that, again, disabled people should have the right to pursue fulfilling their physical and emotional needs. In order to decide, says Vice, who's entitled to use their services, Hand Angel assesses an applicant's level of disability. The person has to be recognized by the government as having a serious physical impairment but cannot be mentally disabled. Once they're cleared, the service is totally free, but each applicant can only receive 3 bouts of sexual stimulation. It doesn't specify if that's within a certain time frame or if it's just
3 bouts?
3 in a lifetime.
3 ever?
3 within your account with the Hand Angels?
Yeah, I don't know. It's a good question. Volunteers, the group of 10 people actually giving the hand jobs, come from varied backgrounds. Some are gay, some are straight, some are disabled themselves, some are PhD students, some are social campaigners, and some work in the media. It's made very clear to me that these volunteers only use their hands for second base kind of stuff, that hugging, caressing, and kissing on the face are all fine, but anything penetrative is not. So going on, when Hand Angel took Andy to the motel, this is the severely disabled man who has never had a date in his whole life and is basically taken care of by his family, the volunteer caressed him thoroughly and then gave him a hand job. He described the intimacy being so intense that for a minute, He believed he was in love. He knew it was only temporary, of course, but the experience provided him with an emotional connection that he had never felt before. This is part of Hand Angel's mission, not just providing a sexual service, but also bringing forth an emotional and social transformation in applicants. I mean, just the idea of providing caressing for this young man is probably a really intimate occasion that he's never had the experience with before. I mean, his family might have given him some semblance of a hug at some point, but again, he's completely disabled, and the hug from grandpa or your mom isn't going to be the same as somebody actually caressing you all over.
Right.
Andy was very introverted before, said Vincent, who's, again, the founder of Hand Angels, and didn't really know how to interact with people. However, through months of talking online, I discovered something changed inside him. When our group was reported by the media and got lots of criticism, I saw Andy joined the public debate and argued with those critical internet users trying to illustrate his opinions. In Taiwan, where discussion of sexuality is restrained by strict moral codes, there was also plenty of mockery that was leveled at Hand Angels. Internet users started posting comments like, quote, do they also offer mouth angels? And I'm retarded. Can I apply for Hand Angel service too?
Oh.
And only three times in a lifetime? Question mark. They're even, of course, welcome to the internet. I mean, there's all kinds of critics.
I'm surprised there wasn't the I'm 12, what's going on here comment.
Well, there was only three that were highlighted by Vice. I'm sure that was in there somewhere. There even appeared to be negativity on an official level. Executive Secretary of Taipei United Social Wealth Alliance, Yi Ting Hu, commented on the non-governmental organization saying, quote, speaking from personal opinion, I don't think we need to bring up disabled people's sexuality as an independent issue. There are more important and urgent problems we need to deal with. Don't you think if you advocate their sexual rights, it's like another form of discrimination? Huh? 855 450 free. You know, I love it when people, these know-it-alls, try to tell other people what they're doing is not a valuable use of their time, that they should be focusing their efforts on something the know-it-all thinks is more important. We hear it all the time.
Yeah.
Up here in New Hampshire. More on the way. It's Free Talk Live.
Inventory isn't about products, kid. It's about money. Products sitting on shelves is money sitting on shelves. I hate overstock. I hate understock. I hate wasting time. I hate wasting money. That's why I love Grainger. Grainger KeepStock solutions help us manage our facility's inventory so we have exactly what we need when we need it. No more, no less. It's inventory management my way. Get it? Got it? Good. Visit Grainger.com/KeepStock for more information. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
Hey, guess what? They've got some great deals for Valentine's Day at guns80.com. They're calling it the Sweetheart Special. Guns80.com has lowered the price way down to $400 up until Valentine's Day. Order your Ghost AR-15 now. Tell your sweetheart that this is the right gift at the right time. Buy one for yourself. Buy one for your sweetheart, too. Your sweetheart will thank you for being so tuned into his or her needs. Get a brand new Ghost AR-15 right now for $400. Heck, buy two. His and hers. Go to guns80.com or call and ask for the sweetheart deal. Love is in the air at guns80.com. Call now, 844-2-GUNS-80. That's 844-248-6780. It's a sweetheart of a deal. Actually, it's a steal at $400. So call guns80.com at 844-2-GUNS-80. But hurry, supplies are limited. Call 844-2-GUNS-80 or get your Ghost AR-15 today at guns80.com on the web.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the
problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Free Talk Live. Dial in toll free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're talking about a very unusual story being reported by Vice.com. And I got to say, I'm such a fan of Vice.com and the work that they do over there. They seem to just kind of come out of nowhere into my world a few years ago when I first watched one of their documentaries about North Korea. And ever since then, I've just been a huge fan of
a
lot of
I had a friend introduce me to Vice, and I've watched a lot of their videos. They're very informative. They really ask a lot of very unusual questions and try to seek out just, you know, again, unusual things. Like going into North Korea, that was incredibly risky.
Yeah, and not but they did it more than once, too.
They've done it more than once, and not a lot of people have done that kind of thing. They've also talked about some of the culture in Japan, like the, you know, the weird, how should I say this, the weird clubs that they have over there. They've talked about, like, child slavery. Really, really controversial, really interesting topics. It's just like, whoa.
Yeah, there was one I watched where this really pretty correspondent they have goes to South China into one area where eating dogs is still fairly accepted.
Oh.
And did a report on that, and she actually ate some dog while she was there. It was pretty interesting.
What did it taste like? Did she say?
Probably like chicken, but I don't remember exactly what she said.
Everything tastes like chicken.
Yeah. Let's go there's a little bit more here to the story, and we're going to go jump right into your phone calls here in a moment. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We also have Skype. You can Skype into the show. Skype username lrn.fm. If you want to comment on Hand Angel, it's a charity, basically, that operates in Taiwan, giving people who have severe disability the intimacy and the pleasure that they probably have never received in their entire lives, if they've been disabled their entire life, as one gentleman, Andy, who they're focusing on in the story, has not, he's basically been taken care of by his family his whole life and is completely disabled, can't even leave the house, that kind of thing. They provide them with hand jobs. And, you know, this isn't supposed to be a particularly titillating topic. We're not trying to pander to the lowest common denominator here. This is reality. Humans desire sexual interactions. Most of them do. There are asexuals, and I think there are different levels of desire for sexual activity among humans.
Right, and the people that are truly asexual, it's a very, 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 very small
1%.
Percentage.
Yeah.
I've heard it was even smaller than that.
Less than a percent? It could be. I've heard as many as 1%, but that's about it.
Right, but some of the people that claim to be asexual will still have desires So the people that are actually asexual that have zero interest.
Well, now, can an asexual... Okay, so is asexuality only the disinterest in sex? Would an asexual also be interested possibly in intimacy in the way of, like, cuddling, just not sex? Is there someone who's not interested in intimacy at all? Would that person be considered an asexual, or is there a broader
I'm not counting people that, you know, want a physical touch, but no intercourse. I'm talking about the people that have absolutely no desire of any kind of having intercourse.
That's what you're defining as asexual.
Yes.
Well, there are also asexuals who will engage in intercourse because they love somebody, right? They still want to be with another person. They want to have the lifestyle of having a partner, for instance, and they will engage in sexual activity with their partner for the benefit of their partner, but not for themselves.
I would say not asexual.
Really? So you're saying you can only be an asexual if you refuse to have sex?
If you're completely celibate and you have no desires at all, then you're asexual.
Yeah, that would be considered asexual.
But okay, I don't think you have to be celibate to be asexual. Asexual.
I'm saying you do.
Okay, well, why don't you look it up? Because I don't think that's the case. You can be celibate without being asexual, and you can also be asexual without being celibate. Your thoughts are certainly welcome at 855-450-FREE. A little bit more here from Vice.com and then to your calls. We're talking about Hand Angels, which is a charity over there. Now, apparently some governmental agent commented on the charity. The executive secretary of the Taipei United Social Wealth Alliance, Yiting Hu, he says, "I don't think we need to bring up disabled people's sexuality as an independent issue. There are more important and urgent problems we need to deal with." And so why... why do people insist on knowing what's right? Like, we hear this all the time as activists. Like, oh, well, you activists in Keene, you're focusing on things like marijuana, freedoms, toplessness. You're focusing on drinking openly. These things aren't important. Shouldn't you be trying to save people from genocide? You ever heard those critiques?
I've heard things similar. I've also heard people say, well, what you should be focusing on is... this, and describe something that we are trying to raise awareness about. should be talking about the wars. Well, we do that, just not today.
Right.
There have been tax day protests where people say, well, you need to be talking about fill in the blank, and it's something that we talked about, you know, the week before or the day before.
Pretty much whenever
you're
protesting, someone's going to have an issue with it and say, you should be doing this. You should be doing that.
It's just so annoying because all these people who are saying, you should be doing. What the hell are they doing? That's what
they're telling you what you should be doing, right? And yelling, get a job.
Because they know what's best, obviously.
Why don't you show us what you think people should be doing rather than just telling us what you think people should be doing? And besides, for these people who are involved in Hand Angels, this is their mission in life, and they believe that it is important. So just because this guy doesn't see the value in it, well, I bet if he all of a sudden lost his legs tomorrow, he might change how he feels about that. You know, if all of a sudden he becomes a quadriplegic and can't move any of his arms or legs, I bet he might maybe open up a little bit on this issue. Of course, the man seems to only be proving Hand Angel's point, according to Vice, to suggest that advocating a disabled person's sexual rights as a form of discrimination is at first patronizing in itself, and secondly, just completely bizarre. How is consensually receiving a hand job in any way discriminatory? Andy, the recipient of the hand job, summed it up saying, quote, "I didn't feel I was the target of pity. The whole process was full of respect and equality. This might be deemed as controversial by society, but as long as you're willing to look into it, what we desire is no different from others." Let's go to Virgil. He's in Columbus, Ohio. You can bring up anything you want here on Free Talk Live. Virgil, go ahead.
Good evening, guys.
Hey there.
Just a quick update, and I've been meaning to try to call in with some events that have happened in Columbus. We had a last Saturday. There was kind of a nationwide, day of outrage against police brutality and torture and things along these lines. And I don't know if you're aware of that or not. But
I had not heard about that.
Yeah, there were demonstrations and protests kind of all over the place. But we had a group of, maybe 100, 150 or so people in Columbus at the state capitol doing a similar thing. And, It took maybe about 2 or 3 hours or so for the event to unfold, and something very interesting happened at the end when two people volunteered to be waterboarded.
Oh, my.
And what? Yeah. And people have asked, you know, why would you do that? And the reason really is because most Americans, most average people have never seen anyone being waterboarded. I haven't.
So the idea was to be waterboarded in front of a crowd of a couple hundred people?
Pretty much. And just kind of demonstrate that it is, in fact, torture, and it is, you know, a very disturbing thing to do to another human being. And remember, this is voluntary, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, the state police, they've been kind of harassing the demonstrators throughout the day, you know, every so often coming and, you know, telling us, kind of directing us, ordering us around. And once the waterboarding started, the first guy got through fairly easily. It was a younger kid, you know, they took it very easy on him. Well, the second volunteer was a former kind of a special ops badass type guy. For real, not, you know, he's not just saying that. He served in the military and he has a lot of experience, and he kind of came around from that, from these status positions. But about 30 seconds, and I have this all on video, about 30 seconds in, we heard the crowd kind of started shouting, you know, badge coming, and, you know, things to that effect. And surely enough, a group of about 6 or so state troopers showed up. One of them came in and physically stopped the waterboarding.
Wow.
He said, the crowd was kind of peppering him with questions. Why? You know, this is volunteer. You got to, you know, leave us alone. And literally the words that came out of his mouth were, "At this moment, I feel like his life is in danger." And he was talking about the volunteer who was being waterboarded.
An admission from an agent of the state as to how intense of a process this is.
Absolutely. It was such a, if we planned this better, it could not have unfolded.
Where would one go to see this video, Virgil?
I will share it on the Free Talk Live page. You guys can share it from there. And, you know, you can post it on Facebook if you want, if
awesome.
That's okay with you.
Thanks for that. And plug your website real quick.
It's virgilpaduva.com.
All right,
that
cool.
That would be just fine.
More coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another micro-loan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket, shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, February 6, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,241, down $23. Silver opened at $16.92, down 30 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $221. Today's precious metal prices brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by eFoods Direct, redefining the way you think about storable food. With civil unrest occurring all across the country, being food secure has never been more important. Visit eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, CDC whistleblower and scientist Dr. William Thompson has allegedly been granted immunity and could possibly testify in front of Congress for his role in fudging numbers in a study related to vaccines and autism. Last year, Thompson turned over thousands of pages of documents to Congressman William Posey's office. Posey serves on the Committee on Science, Space, and Technology. The Daily Caller reports that a spokesman for Posey confirmed his office had received documents from Thompson, which he said related to a manipulated study. The Daily Caller goes on to say the Obama administration had granted Thompson immunity. The scientist is currently still working with the CDC. The Transportation Security Administration, the Philadelphia Police Department, and the Department of Homeland Security are being sued after arresting a man on false charges and lying about the facts in court. In 2013, Roger Vanderklok was stopped and questioned by TSA workers over Power Bar snacks and a watch in his bag. Vanderklok says there was a misunderstanding between him and the TSA. After his bag was cleared of hazardous materials, he asked to file a complaint. Instead, he was put into a holding area, and the Philadelphia police were called. He was arrested and charged with threatening the placement of a bomb and making terroristic threats. At his trial, a TSA supervisor claimed Vanderklok was getting agitated, waving his hands in the air, and threatened to bring a bomb through security. However, surveillance video proved the supervisor was lying, and Vanderklok was acquitted. He's now suing the agencies for their participation in depriving him of his liberty. The Liberty Beat is made possible by Justice Ranvier's bitcoinism.liberty.me. Thoughts on Bitcoin and the future digital economy. Check out the blog at bitcoinism.liberty.me. Support also comes from My Magic Mud, detoxifying tooth powder, the most effective and affordable dental care around. Get a 150 application jar at mymagicmud.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 6, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. A new study published in the Journal of Neuroscience has found that daily cannabis use is not connected to brain shrinkage when the effects of alcohol consumption are considered. Neuroscientists at the University of Colorado at Boulder reviewed scientific papers that concluded cannabis use caused parts of the brain to shrink and found the studies were not consistent. By matching daily cannabis users with non-users based on alcohol consumption, the researchers were able to account for the influence of alcohol on brain shrinkage. They found no measurable difference in the size of the brain between those who consumed cannabis daily and those who did not. Nearly 2 years after the Austin Police Department shot and killed Julian Reyes's dog Shinerbach, he continues the fight for justice. In April 2013, Reyes and Shinerbach were confronted by police who were responding to a call for suspicious activity at a local storage unit. Austin police said Shinerbach was growling and would not listen to commands, so the officer shot the dog for protection. Since that time, Reyes has said he has been attacked by police and arrested by police for filming. In a Facebook post, Reyes asked for help from the community, stating, quote, "My time has been spent fighting for justice and change, and I cannot continue without help." Support for Liberty Beat comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Want to reach tens of thousands of like-minded listeners every day with your message or product? The Liberty Beat is looking for sponsors for their daily news service. Support this grassroots media project while expanding your reach to a targeted market. To find out more, just go online to libertybeat.com/advertise. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 6, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
This is the Onion Week in Review.
According to friends, colleagues, and complete strangers, anxiety-ridden man Timothy Gibula is rightly ashamed of every single thing he does, with mere acquaintances saying they're constantly judging Gibula at every moment, just as he suspects.
Tim's the kind of guy who's forever second-guessing his behavior, as if everyone's constantly scrutinizing him, and he's completely correct. We all are.
We can spend entire afternoons picking apart Tim's taste in clothing and his receding hairline. It's honestly all we do when he's not around.
Anytime he awkwardly says excuse me when he's waiting in line for milk or sugar, anytime he fails to make eye contact with me when he asks me for the Wi-Fi password, not only do I notice these things, but I use them to judge him fundamentally as a human being.
A three-alarm fire that tore through a family home in Newark, Delaware early Saturday morning tragically claimed a half sleeve of Oreo cookies that were trapped inside a cupboard. At the time of the blaze, the residence was occupied by Mike and Sheila Donlin, their three young children, and six delicious chocolate sandwich cookies, all half dozen of which perished in the intense heat and towering flames.
Welcome to Free Talk Live. You dial toll-free to take control of the airwaves here. We can talk about the Pope's views about spanking, as though anyone really cares what the Pope thinks. But apparently, I mean, not that anyone on this show cares, but apparently some people do. So we'll share those with you. Danica, you've got that story tonight. It is Ian, Danica, and Daryl in the studio. You can join us on the phones, also on Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. If you're just tuning in, we've had a couple of unusual topics tonight. One of them is about a Mongolian monk who is the Buddhist folk that are from his temple or whatever. They are saying that he's still alive. He's in a meditative state after 200 years of meditation in a cave.
That's the Dalai Lama's physician that made that determination that he is still in a state of meditation, a state called Tukdam, that's T-U-K-D-A-M, and that he is close to becoming a Buddha.
The state prior to total enlightenment. So there was that discussion we had, plus Hand Angel, a Taiwanese non-governmental organization, basically a charity providing hand jobs to the severely disabled. So you can talk about any of that or whatever's on your mind. Let's go to Tom, listening in Cedar City, Utah, to KZNU. Hey, Tom.
Hi. I'm talking about your subject of celibacy, or being celibate, not meaning to be.
Well, see, we covered a couple different things. We covered the idea of celibacy versus being an asexual. What were you trying to get at there, Tom?
Okay. Not being asexual, but being asexual, but not wanting to be.
Being asexual, but not wanting to. Meaning that you have no drive for sex, but at the same time, you wish you did.
Well, I'm confused whether I do or not.
You're confused whether or not you have a drive for sex?
Yes, because I think I do, but it comes across that I don't.
Tell me more. What makes you feel that way?
Parents.
Well, you sound like your parents. You sound like you're definitely out of your parents' house. How old are you, Tom?
I'm 54.
Right.
Okay. But the point I'm trying to make is, you go your whole life. It starts very young, and you don't. When you're real young, you're not noticing what's going on with you and how things are being evolved in your, you know, in your conscience or in your development for things like sex and attraction to the other sex and how you're going to demonstrate it or show it to the other person when you get to the age that you need to. And I believe that parents are very, very instrumental in giving you a wrong feeling about that. And you evolve not knowing that's what's going on. And it happens, and you look back and you see you go your whole life without even noticing it because you're happy-go-lucky as a youth in your youth. You're not even noticing those kind of things or thinking about those kind of things.
So let me see if I'm following what you're saying here. You were raised in a household where your parents did not acknowledge sexuality. They didn't talk to you about, you know, what you might be experiencing as a teenage boy, for
instance.
Did they
try to shame you at all for when?
I believe they tried to close you out in a lot of ways. In sure. other words, I also believe that maybe perhaps you were the one they didn't want. Okay.
So you felt like that you were an unwanted child? Is that correct?
Well, I strongly believe that there's a lot of us in that category.
Oh, sure. I think that's true.
Sure, certainly.
And I believe more of us don't want to admit it or even want to know that for the truth. Mm-hmm. That, but there's also people, I believe there's parents really engaged in the fact that they don't want you to become something that they are experiencing, and for some reason, because of their either the fact that you were a boy and not a girl when you popped out, you know, nowadays it doesn't happen that way. They already know, but
they already know what? I'm sorry.
Parents generally know if they're going to have a boy or a girl.
I'm going off topic a little bit. Just the fact that back in the old days, they didn't know you were going to be a boy or girl when you popped out.
Okay.
As they do now. But the thing is, my feeling is that it stays, that conditioning stays in you, and you don't even pay attention to it. You don't even know it's happening, and you have a hard time dealing with the circumstances and the results of your interaction, and you get depressed because you have a failed you fail in a relationship, and it seemed like she was more interested in you than she turned out to say that she was, but everything points to the fact that maybe she was interested in you, and now here's this part about you that she's noticing that you've never really experienced or took
the part about you. When you say part about you, you mean your sexuality that you feel had been repressed due to your parents, the way they raised you,
your conditioning, and other things. Help supporting that. Just your psychological conditioning.
Sure, your physical.
Your conditioning, and yet, so she moved on. In my experience, the girl I fell in love with conceived a kid that committed suicide. So, and I am really mad about that.
With you?
No. With another guy. And I believe those kids should have been mine. Hmm. You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying that she got me to fall in love with her, and as it turns out, she dumped me, and conceived with another guy, but yet I'm the one that she gave the feelings to. And
I don't know if she gave the feelings to you, but you definitely had feelings for her. Now, we've definitely gone off from the original thrust of your call. Not that that's a bad thing, but I just want to make sure we kind of tie it all back in if possible. I don't know if we want to stray too far afield. So you've got concerns with the way that your parents raised you, trying to suppress any idea of sexuality. And then later on, you feel like that's affected you in your relationships somehow, wherein you haven't had as fulfilling relationships as you might have hoped. You didn't have kids as you might have thought that you should, and you're somehow blaming yourself and or your parents for that?
Well, I'm blaming them because they seem to not they seem to have never wanted to admit to anything like that, but
so meaning they wouldn't admit to having repressed you.
My mom has passed away. My dad's still alive, and so I still hold the grudge against my dad. But anyway,
so when you say they won't admit, you mean they won't admit to having been repressive in their way of raising you?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I mean,
very disinterested in. And my development,
I see.
And so forth. And I went to, I got, okay, I went.
Well, it seems like parents, it seems like a lot of parents want to prevent that development, right? And they have good rationale
for
it.
Sure, they do. And, you know, and parents, I mean, they're just like us. They make mistakes. They try to raise their kids. Most parents do try to raise their kids the best way that they feel is possible. And then when the kids are older and the kids have issues, they may not have realized, oh, wow, we totally messed that up.
I want to get into that, too, because I go to counseling for that, okay? And I find out that the counseling I get when I go to private counseling they seem to not address the issue. It's just like what you're saying, that the parents tried their best. Well, I really don't believe Adam Lanza, the Newtown, Connecticut kids, parents tried their best with him. I don't believe that.
Okay, not all parents are meant to be parents. Right. I totally agree. There are some pretty messed up people out there.
Well, but sometimes the reason for this sexual repression, they rationalize that. I'm not saying it's right.
Right.
I'm just sort of
exactly.
explaining it. So, like, for instance, one of the classic reasons would be that they don't want you to knock some girl up as a teenager. That's a fairly good reason to not have sexual intercourse. And at the same time, but if they're completely repressing the idea of sexuality, instead of just informing you about sex, which is a way a lot of parents will go about that, instead of actually talking, then that can really, I think, cause some damage. Tom, hang on a second here. Daryl's been absorbing all this. You've got some questions or some thoughts, observations for Tom. And if you want to talk to Tom, 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
When the leading antihistamine and Nasacort go nose-to-nose, Nasacort wins, stopping more of the chemical responses that can cause your nasal allergy symptoms. And when you stop more causes, you get 24-hour relief from sneezing, an itchy runny nose, even congestion. It's prescription-strength medicine available over-the-counter. Nasacort Allergy 24-hour. Stops more of what makes you miserable. Use as directed.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
Hey, I'm Ian Freeman, one of the hosts of Free Talk Live. I created Free Talk Live in 2002 as an alternative to traditional talk radio. I wanted a show where anyone could call in and bring up any topic without fear of being screened out. Combined with our libertarian, voluntarist viewpoints, Free Talk Live is a unique syndicated radio show heard on FM and AM radio stations, coast to coast and beyond. I moved from my birthplace of Florida to New Hampshire in 2006 as part of the Free State Project. I'm also the program director of LRN.FM, which I launched in 2009 to create a place to present the best liberty-oriented audio programs from around the globe. I perform liberty outreach of all sorts and have done civil disobedience, non-cooperation, and run for office multiple times. Much of that's covered on my blog at freekeen.com. Thank you for listening to our shows. And if you want to support our work, please visit amp.freetalklive.com and contribute just $5 a month to our effective liberty outreach. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You may dial toll-free here. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And join us online over at freetalklive.com. Tonight, with you in studio, me, Ian.
Danica.
And Daryl.
And you've heard about Bitcoin. You've maybe have heard about blockchains. But what does it all mean for you? You can go to the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference coming up March 28th and 29th at the Moody Theater in downtown Austin, and you'll find out. Keynote speakers will include the world-famous investor, economist, and author George Gilder, plus IBM's architect of their blockchain technology, Sumbala Nair, will be flying in from India. David Johnson will be there, Jason King, Robert Murphy, Vitalik Buterin, Charlie Shrem, and other speakers still getting lined up. It's the biggest Bitcoin event going, especially since the second annual Bitcoin or Texas Bitcoin Conference will also be hosting the second $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon. If you want a glimpse into the future going even beyond Bitcoin, you'll want to be in Austin, Texas, coming up March 28th and 29th. Go to TexasBitcoinConference.com. You can register for your tickets there, and don't forget to use code FTL to get $25 off the already fairly affordable price of just $150 for the weekend there. Or I don't actually, is it a weekend? Honestly, I haven't looked to see if
it's a weekend.
It is a weekend? Okay, good. Because I know last year Texas Bitcoin Conference actually happened in the middle of the week. So that's, I think, a good move on their part to move it to the weekend, to move it to downtown Austin.
You did say 28th, 29th, correct?
Correct.
That's a weekend,
okay,
Saturday, Sunday.
So, yeah, knock $25 off the already affordable registration fee by using code FTL. And then another $25 of your fee will be donated to Sean's Outpost, which is doing great work for homeless folks in Florida. TexasBitcoinConference.com. Sean's Outpost, by the way, Bitcoin-only charity. TexasBitcoinConference.com. Code is FTL. We were there last year, and we'll be there broadcasting live again.
You mentioned Charlie Shrem. Will this be his last appearance before he goes to jail?
Ooh, I don't know. When is he supposed to check in?
It was, I think, 60 days after his sentencing, and I don't remember what day he got sentenced.
It seems like it's been at least a month, but I don't know.
You might want to double-check the Charlie Shrem.
It says Charlie Shrem here.
I know it says that on there. I'm saying you might want to check with the people at Texas Bitcoin Conference
Maybe they'll teleconference him in from a jail cell.
Right. I don't know if he's actually going to physically be there.
Yeah, it's a good question. I mean, I presume he's going to be in a minimum security federal prison, so maybe they've got video conferencing. I mean, here in Keene, New Hampshire, you can connect with a video conference to the people that are in the jail.
Right.
So, I don't know. Charlie Shrem is going to be in some way supposedly involved. I guess we'll find out.
I'm just saying, you might want to double-check on Monday.
Yeah, and if you want, check in and see when it was that he was sentenced, because that might be illuminating in this matter. Anyway, go to TexasBitcoinConference.com. Code is FTL. We'll look forward to seeing you there as we go back to Tom. He's calling from Utah, listening to KZNU. Now, Tom, we were talking a little bit during the break about your situation, and of course, one of the big obvious questions is you're in Utah. Were your parents, who you've described as very sexually repressive towards you when you were growing up, and you're in your 50s now, but were your parents Mormons? I'm just curious.
Yes, but not dogmatic type.
Well,
in other words, my siblings had no problem.
Your siblings had no problem what?
They all got married and were able to express themselves with partners easily.
I see.
Interesting.
They have it understood by their significant others what they were hoping for.
Daryl, you had some comments or questions or something.
I did.
For Tom.
So, The whole time I was trying to recall this quote, so I've actually pulled it up. It's from Robert Goldrick, and he writes in a book called The End of the World as We Know It, "If you don't receive love from those who are meant to love you, you will never stop looking for it.
Hmm.
And there's a lot of people that I think that this really rings true for. But in regards to sort of the sexuality aspect, one thing that sort of happened to me growing up in Alabama, because, you know, Alabama's a much more conservative place than, you know, say, New Hampshire. And I'm sure Utah's very similar as far as, you know, the moral aspects go. I was always told, sex is bad. Mm. Don't do it. So here I am thinking, okay, so sex is bad, so I shouldn't do sex with somebody that I like because I don't want to do bad things with somebody that I like. And so then it winds up messing with your brain. And if things mess with your brain for too long, then, you know, you wind up being 50 years old and not really knowing how to express yourself.
That's very close. And I appreciate you guys giving me your time to have this, to say my piece, you know?
Sure.
So I want to let you know that. And
is that what you were taught, though, by your parents, is that sex is bad?
Or was there just no addressing
it whatsoever?
I just think they were very negative people for me. They were very negative in all areas of my development. Very, very, very repressive in many areas.
How many siblings do you have, Tom?
I'll give you one example of my dad being very repressive. I enlisted in the Marines at age 22, and he was an ex-Marine, and he got his whole career and his livelihood and his love life from being in the Marine Corps. Well, I enlisted in the Marines at age 22, and he got into the Master Gunnery Sergeant's head about me having seizures as a little infant, and it gave me an honorable discharge, and he got me out of the Marines, and he said, "Well, I'm doing it for your good, and we can work on some other areas to pursue our goal." I'm not happy about that.
Well, you know, maybe he saved your life in that way. It's probably not a bad thing.
No, this is 1984, so I would have been under the Reagan administration then.
I see.
So, in anyway, but...
So, I mean, today, you've got a situation where you're in your 50s. Do you have a relationship today, or are you alone at the moment?
I do not. And I'm afraid that I am just starting to rediscover how much of an effect it all had on me, you know, about 5 years ago. And I'm looking for counseling. They don't seem to be addressing the issue the way I need them to. You know, I want to get right to the core things, and they keep talking about, like, kind of what we're talking about here. Well, your parents meant to be their best and all this. And I'm going, well, that's not what I want to get at. I want to get at me being able to want to express myself and know how that's supposed to be understood. You know,
well, I think that you've done a decent job expressing yourself here tonight, Tom, and I don't know what the right solution is or if there is one that's going to ultimately solve a problem that has been with you for so long. But maybe some sort of group therapy, maybe a group of people who have similar circumstances in life.
I haven't tried that, and I'm thinking about it, but I really fear that it'll be also a very negative experience for me, and I don't want any more, you know.
Well, you can always leave, right? I mean, if it turns out to be something that you weren't expecting, then you can terminate that. I always find myself suspicious of these therapists, right? Like that you're going to pay, I don't know, what is it, $50, $100 an hour or something crazy like that?
That's on the low end.
Just to have someone sit there and basically listen to you talk. You have to call here for free and talk to us. Not that we've got a degree or anything like that, or that the degree somehow makes the people with the degree more qualified to listen to you. Thanks, Tom, for the call tonight. I appreciate it, and good luck. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And maybe you've got some comments for Tom, or you can relate to his situation with a very repressive parental upbringing. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And does the opposite work? A very allowing parental upbringing, or is there some sort of middle ground that's more appropriate? It's Free Talk Live.
How many good people procrastinate? When was the last time you updated your last will and testament, your living will, and your health care power of attorney? If you could get these documents and membership for no additional charge, wouldn't it just make sense to have the peace of mind of owning a Legal Shield membership? Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com, or call 855 855- 340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts not available to the little guy. Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's togethersave.com. Togethersave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. Togethersave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at togethersave.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Majid lives in Nordevin, Armenia, with his wife, kids, and grandkids, all in the same house. They have cows, but to compete against the big ranchers, Majid needed to get a loan for more cattle. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the cows. He bought them, and now he's very happy with the expansion of his farm. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel at any time. coffee.freetalklive.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You are welcome to dial in toll-free to bring up whatever you'd like. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Inadvertently, we ended up on the topic due to your calls. So you can bring up anything you want. The topic of kind of sexually repressive parents and parenting styles that result in some unfortunate mental circumstances later on in life, as our last caller was experiencing in his 50s, sort of, as he was saying, just coming to the realization of some of the damage that was done to him by his parents. And, of course, in my opinion, another way to damage your kids is to spank them. The Pope, however, says that it's totally fine, with one caveat. And, Danica, you've got the story here about that. But first, I want to tell you about how to express your love for your loved ones on Valentine's Day. Show her you thought of something unique and different this year and get her the gift that she's sure to love. Or he, because I'm telling you,
anybody is going to love Sherry's Berries. If you love chocolate, strawberries, and you love the idea of them together, you're going to love Sherry's Berries. In fact, they're freshly dipped strawberries from Sherry's Berries available at just $19.99. It's over a 40% savings off their over at berries.com. Go to berries, berries.com. And to get the deals that we're going to talk about here, use code FTL. Now, the deal, in my opinion, that you want to go with is not just the $19.99. Add $10 more and you double the berries. So this is something you're going to want to do, because if you're ordering for somebody who you really care about, you're going to want to share with them. And if you're ordering for yourself, you're going to want to have twice as much, because they're just so good. They're so scrumptious. And they seem to pick the best strawberries for Sherry's Berries. And I don't know how they go about doing that, but somehow they're selecting like the A-grade top shelf.
Oh, Sherry really knows what she's doing.
That's awesome.
Whoever it is that's picking those strawberries over there. I would presume Sherry has hired someone at this point.
Sherry has minions. I'm sure she has minions.
To handle that. But whoever it is, they're doing a great job. And they're topped with chocolate chips, decorative swizzle, or nuts. We've talked about Sherry's Berries a lot here on Free Talk Live. And I'm a huge fan. I think this is a great gift. Now, it's Valentine's Day. That's what's coming up here. That's the special offer that's on the table at the moment. Code FTL is what you want to use to get the deals. Again, click the microphone at berries.com. And remember, when you order with code FTL, that gives us credit. There's a lot of places on talk radio where you hear about Sherry's Berries. Like, I don't know, it seems like every other talk show host is talking about Sherry's Berries. These guys are well-advertised product, and that's because they're doing good work and it's a good product. But there's a zillion talk show hosts that are promoting this. If you use code FTL, we get the credit for it. And of course, when that happens, Sherry's Berries is more likely to come back and order or buy more advertising with Free Talk Live. So if you've been thinking about getting somebody, getting your loved one something this Valentine's Day, forget about the jewelry, forget about the flowers. Go with something that you can put in your belly, because you know what? You can't go wrong.
Flowers die. Strawberries are delicious.
Oh, yes, they sure are. So berries.com, code FTL. Our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. Danica, you've got a story that kind of ties in with this whole bad parenting theme that we've had so far this hour. And I think it's bad parenting. Maybe you guys will agree or disagree. I think it's terrible parenting to spank your kids.
Yeah, it was really interesting how the previous caller brought that. I was just thinking, you know what? That has a really interesting tie-in. Mm-hmm. So the article that I'm going to be sharing is from NBCWashington.com, and the headline is, Pope says it's okay to spank kids if their dignity is kept.
I don't see how that's even possible, but I'd love to hear what he has to say.
Well, I mean, I'll go into more description about the article. Basically, keeping the dignity in a nutshell is to just obviously you never strike your children in anger. Like, let's say Tommy broke, you know, the vase that has grandma's ashes in it. You're furious and you want to just like, you know, probably beat the kid up. But you need to be able to discipline yourself and be like, no.
I'll beat you later, son.
I'll beat you later, but not as hard as I possibly could be. That's his rationale for that.
There are also things that parents can do, even without striking the child, that will wind up causing, you know, mental duress to the child.
Like, oh, you mean like slamming their head into a wall?
No, I'm not even talking about that. I'm talking, you know, like... you accidentally knock over the vase and then you yell and scream at the child, calling them every swear word you can think of.
I hate you and I wish I never had you.
Oh,
something
man.
Like that.
That would be a mild version of what I'm thinking. But, you know, like telling your child that they're worthless and that they can't do anything
right.
They're stupid. And then, you know, listing off this long list of swears that would make a sailor start to blush. Even though you never lay a hand on them, that is still going to damage the child in some way.
Well, hopefully if the parent is yelling at the kids, they have the decency to not, you know, swear at them and call them. You know, they may, you know, just say that they're, you know, you're thoughtless, you're careless.
I don't think the swears make a difference. I mean, if you're telling a kid they are thoughtless, clumsy, and useless, then that's as bad as calling them names.
You know, right.
But that's really,
you know, most parents that are going to do that are also going to throw swear words in.
Maybe, yeah.
Yeah, well, then they can put a blame about who Tommy starts swearing from. So, anywho, Pope Francis says it's okay to spank your children to discipline them.
And where's this story from?
It's from NBCWashington.com. Okay. As long as their dignity is maintained. Francis made the remarks this week during his weekly general audience, which was devoted to the role of fathers in the family.
Okay.
So Francis outlined the traits of a good father. One who forgives, but who is able to, and I quote, correct with firmness while not discouraging the child. One time, I heard a father in a meeting with married couples say, I sometimes have to smack my children a bit, but never in the face as to not humiliate them, Francis says. How beautiful, Francis remarked. He knows the sense of dignity. He has to...
Beautiful. He thinks it's beautiful yeah. to physically attack your child. So long as you don't hit them in the face. Go ahead and hit them somewhere else. That's okay. They'll keep their dignity. This is what I want to know, and I know there are people who advocate spanking out there, and again, I don't know where you guys fall on this yet, but from those who do advocate spanking, how do you spank with dignity? Because it seems to me that it is an undignified thing to do in any way, shape, or form.
Well, there would be some people that would argue that putting a child in a timeout is not dignified because you are then, you know, basically shaming the child for having done something wrong.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I'm guessing that there are some parents that think that, you know, no form of discipline is good for a child. Just That's let true. Them do whatever.
There are those parents.
If they wind up getting hit by a bus, well, you know, they'll learn not to run out in traffic again.
Oh, yeah. I mean, growing up, but the role of punishment in the household until I was about probably 10 years old, I want to say, was spanking.
Ooh.
Like, yeah, I was spanked as a child.
With what implements?
What do you mean?
Well, like, if I have to ask the question. Probably...
A belt? Did you grab something off of the
did
tree?
They have
like,
a,
no, my
did
switch.
You go pick your own
my
switch?
My father was actually beaten by my grandfather with a belt. I thankfully never had to endure
that
kind
of
pain.
What about one of those paddles with the holes in them?
Yeah. You know, the hand was used, the paddle was used.
Oh, okay.
The cooking spoon of some kind.
Oh,
that,
really?
Those were the, you know, typically made out of wood, not silicone or anything
like
that.
When I was in high school, they actually brought back corporal punishment in the school.
They brought it back in high school?
Yes. And the principal had retired.
Welcome to Alabama.
So the football coach wound up filling in for the principal for the last half of the year. And one of the guys that we called Tiny. Tiny
was a big guy,
was
right?
6'8".
Yeah.
We don't know how much he weighed. The scale went to 400 and he was over that.
Whoa.
Tiny got sent to the principal's office. And Coach Wood. All right, Tiny, bend over. Whacked
what?
Him with the paddle so hard that Tiny got lifted up off his feet.
How's that possible?
How is that even possible? That's unbelievable.
Well, you hit somebody hard enough, they're going to lose their balance and come off their feet.
See. Wow.
That's what happened with Tiny, and nobody did anything. They heard that story, and you know everybody was good for the rest of the year.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Oh, man. I remember vaguely that when I was in elementary school, there was a paddle in the principal.
Spanked in school.
I don't think I ever was. No. But I remember that that existed. I remember hearing about that.
I feel like
I remember seeing the paddle at some point. But and at some point, that went away. And thankfully, they didn't bring it back in high school because I would have gotten it in high school. That's for sure. 855, 450-FREE. More coming up on Free Talk Live.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Khalid lives in Gaza. He makes his living as a taxi driver. The engine in his old beater blew up. Now, he makes good money driving people in his cab, but he couldn't afford the $1,300 for a new engine. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the engine, and he's back on the road. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. Coffee.freetalklive.com.
On Facebook, on the news, and in conversations with friends, we're bombarded every day with advice on how to be healthier, from gluten-free and non-GMO diets to how much exercise and sleep the body needs. But how much have you heard about alkalizing the body? AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops are a holistic and natural way to get your body's pH levels back in balance. Just a few drops in water will help your body rid itself of harmful waste, and even the healthiest of diets can be complemented with your daily use of AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops. Who isn't looking for more vibrance, vigor, and energy? Now buy two bottles of AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops and get $10 off your order. Visit AlkaVision.com or call 800-518-7615. AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops are packed with a powerful combination of the most alkaline minerals and compounds. Open the door to greater health, vitality, and zest for life. Alkalize your body. Supercharge your health. Call 800-518-7615 or head to AlkaVision.com.
When commercials come on, don't push the button. Instead, listen. Even if you don't sell things for a living, you're still selling in the various conversations and transactions that make up your busy day. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important, especially if you're a job seeker. So take a lesson from Madison Avenue. Often the fewer words, the more effective the message. Like Jiffy Lube, where you never need an appointment, or the Office Max ad that says, "You supply the ambition, we supply everything else." How about online ticket broker StubHub.com, the way in when it's sold out, or CyberCupid Match.com's seductive, "Go ahead, it's okay to look." How cleverly and succinctly can you distill your message? For more tips, hit SurvivalSpeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Antiwar, pro-free market. That's Antiwar.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll free to bring up what you want here in these remaining moments. We might have enough time to get you on the air at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, it's Ian,
Danica,
and Daryl.
Don't forget to check more of Daryl out over on his website, fpp.cc. There's much more written Daryl there. He's an editor of books. You can buy those books with only Bitcoin. Isn't that right? You don't take anything
else? Only Bitcoin at the Bitcoin shop on fpp.cc. If you want to use credit cards or other payment, then there's the shopping iframe built into the website that you can do that. It goes through a third party, not through me. But if you purchase directly from me, you can only do that with Bitcoin.
FPP.cc, your other website, fppradio.com, yes, for more audio form, Daryl.
Been doing the 5-minute daily newscast for over 1 year.
Wow, congratulations. I didn't realize that had already passed.
Yes, began February 3rd of last year. Today's episode was, I think, the 366th, because there were 3 days missing when I was in jail last year.
Still the only liberty-oriented podcast produced, 5-minute newscast produced 5 days or 7 days a week.
Yes.
So that's awesome.
Again, fppradio.com. Now, Danica, we were talking about spanking, and you had said, you'd revealed that your parents had utilized that up until you were about 10 years old.
Yes, for me and my three other siblings, yes.
And the Pope, and you said they used their hands and they used, like, wooden spoons.
A wooden spoon, yeah.
Now, the Pope has said that it's okay to spank your kids.
Probably because nuns will use the rulers to slap kids on the wrist.
As long as they keep their dignity. Now, when you were being spanked, do you recall as though you felt as though you had dignity in that circumstance?
No, I mean, I remember being upset. You know, I was, you know, obviously crying at that point because it's painful. And
did they do it through your when you had clothes on, or did they make you drop your drawers?
Most of the time, I had my clothes on still. Okay. You could argue
that would be keeping some level of dignity, I suppose.
I suppose, yeah. I mean, I guess if it's, you know, completely bare bottom there, you know, there's a level of just absolute shame in there. And they, you know, they always try to embrace me afterwards, trying to make it seem like they still love me. And of course, I'm just kind of like, get away from me.
It felt hollow, I imagine.
It's just kind of like, okay, what are you doing? You know, first
this hurt me more than it hurt you.
Oh, yeah. How many times have I heard that? But I mean, you know, here I am in like absolute pain, angry and upset. And here they are trying to hug me. It's just like, no, get away.
Daryl, can you relate to this before we go to our calls?
I don't recall ever being spanked.
Really? That's good.
I may have been. My dad has said that he never had to spank me. But like
you
I said,
were just
I
just a good boy.
I don't recall. Oh no, I wasn't a good boy. I just, you know, when I did things wrong, I didn't get caught. So I like I said, I don't recall if I ever was or not.
Let's go to your calls and thoughts. We got you can bring up anything you want. Clay's in Shelton, Washington, listening to KMAS. Hello, Clay.
Hello.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, well, I heard you talking about this guy who was meditating, and
yeah,
I had some thoughts on that.
Sure.
So the question was whether he was meditating or whether he was dead.
Yeah, for our listeners who are maybe just tuning in, you're referencing something from the first hour of our show with a Buddhist monk who was found in a cave after 200 years, basically. I'm shortening the story.
Right.
But he's mummified, according to science, but the folks at the Buddhist temple there are saying that he is, in point of fact, meditating and is a very deep state of meditation nearing nirvana.
And not just someone from a Buddhist temple, the Dalai Lama's
doctor.
Physician.
Go ahead, Clay. What do you think?
Wow, 200 years. I didn't realize it was actually 200 years. I thought it was more much shorter amount of time.
Well, there's the we were actually talking about two different stories. There was one from India where the Hindu guru in January of last year, according to doctors and his family, had a heart attack. According to his followers, he entered a deep state of meditation. So there were two different stories about deep meditation / death right. that we were talking about.
Right. That's the one, the Indian guru.
Okay.
So it was between the followers and his family?
Yes.
I just wanted to say that if he was truly in a deep state of meditation, and his followers took him from that state and put him in the freezer. Didn't they murder him? Just throwing it out.
Well, they're saying that
question.
They're preserving him for when he wakes up.
Right. Yeah. Do people wake up from being frozen like that? I mean,
no, I don't think that they would.
I guess it depends on how cold the freezer is.
Well, generally you consider a freezer to be below freezing, or freezing or below, right? So that's going to slow
right.
down.
But could also be, you know, some form of mistranslation from the Hindu
refrigerator
to something. Right, so it could be something that's, you know, 60 degrees that would be refrigerated.
Yeah, I think Clay's
right.
making a good point, though. It's an interesting
definitely a good point.
Detail. Mm-hmm. Clay, anything else you want to share?
Or perhaps it's cryogenic freezing. I don't know.
But either way, you're right. I mean, there is a legitimate point to be made that if they truly believed he was still alive, that putting him in a freezer is certainly not going to help bring him back.
Unless, exactly. again, unless it's that cryogenic right, yeah. thing that they use for time travel.
Well, but we still don't know if that technology exists.
Has anybody ever been brought back from cryogenic?
No, and that's the thing. I don't know. Have they done it successfully with any animals? I think they have, but
I don't know.
Or like bugs. I think they might have done it with bugs or whatever, but I don't know. That's a good question. It's beyond my range of expertise, which of course is nothing more than doing a talk radio show. Thanks, Clay, for your call tonight. I appreciate it, man. Let's go to Nathan. He's in Texas on Skype. Hello, Nathan.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
It doesn't surprise me what you said about the Pope. Actually, something similar is true of the Dalai Lama, since Daryl brought it up. They have a special whip, the Dalai Lama, which is apart from the other whip, which is to whip the other students at the monasteries.
Okay.
Well, I think the point I'm trying to make is that this is actually from a Molyneux video he recently did about the Dalai Lama. The problem with mysticism, and this is like kind of taking the Pope into this, is that you can't have a religious leader who spells out every single thing, right? That's not really practical. So what you wind up with are prophets who try to interpret what the deity or holy book or whatnot says. And so then when they say things like, oh, well, it's good to spank, it's good to, use violence against your children, that doesn't look very good, at least from my viewpoint, because it either means you're not very good at interpreting your deity or your deity is not very moral.
Yeah, I'd say that's a fairly accurate assessment. I'm not interested in becoming a Catholic, and hearing things like that does not increase my interest in becoming a Catholic. Because I think spanking is abhorrent and it's violence against children, and I think it's unacceptable. But it's your family, so I wouldn't do anything about it. Like if I knew that somebody was spanking their kids, it would be none of my business. I wouldn't.
But if you knew that they were beating their kid to where there were bruises and the kid was always complaining of I don't want to go home.
Well, I think that. Young people should be able to emancipate themselves. So, yeah, I think that if a young person wants to get out of an abusive household, that people would be out there who'd be willing to help that person in order to escape. Sort of like the people that help the folks from the Fundamentalist Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints escape their compounds out in the middle of the desert in Arizona and Utah. Obviously the people who run the compounds would prefer their kids not escape, but there are people who are willing to help them, many of whom are formerly of those compounds. And I think that that's heroic work.
And when you say people trying to help, you're not talking about the taxpayer-funded CPS that basically kidnaps children from parents.
No, I'm talking about volunteer people who many of them have been previously in those circumstances themselves, and they know how repressive and awful of a life it is, and so they want to
help.
And
they offer a network of counseling and help, job help, school help, or anything like that.
Nathan, thanks for your call tonight. Appreciate it. Let's bring Chris Kringle on here. You're on Free Talk Live.
I'd like to make a comment about spanking and also about hand angels,
Okay. Go fast.
Well, the first comment is this. You know who really needs to be spanked? The rabbi needs to take you in the middle of the open church, and he needs to hit you with a hickory stick, probably, I think, 35 times.
I thought you were going to say he needs to throw stones, because that sounds like something that you would maybe suggest.
He needs to spank you and keep spanking you and make your bottom turn or extremely red.
What's the safe word?
He's going to spank you. Why? Because you bring up this masturbation stuff, and that's disgusting. That's of the devil. So he needs to take your hide and go and just hit you with a stick.
That would really
get you
off,
wouldn't it,
Chris?
So what's the safe word?
I don't know. It's what? Good riddance for tonight, because he's gone. We'll see you tomorrow night online. In the meantime, freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live, the show where anyone can call about whatever they want. And we do mean anyone.
World fast for peace.
I don't understand what you said.
If the whole world fasted like Gandhi, we would see great results for this struggle to survive world order.
There's never going to be any peace. You sound like you're on drugs, dear. It sounds like you're a flower child. You're pumped up on drugs.
Any woman who doesn't agree with you is on drugs or something.
I may be a racist and anti-Semite, but I have all my faculties.
Well, racism and sexism are one.
You're one of those love mankind, love thy neighbor.
And I am too. And thank you both for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. That is the one thing I can certainly agree with the lady on. Normally, I can't understand a word that she says, but I think Scott, the bigot, did interpret her correctly and that she is interested in peace. And I like that.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
The Corey Moore Show is coming up next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, February 6th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.09 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,250 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $219. Antiwar.com reports, fresh from his latest NATO meeting, Secretary of Defense Chuck Hagel warned that there is a growing division within the alliance along a north-south axis. Hagel saw the problem as twofold and seemed to blame southern member nations on both counts, saying the North wants to focus on the growing threat from Russia, while the southern nations are worried about North Africa. There's a big, obvious division, but Hagel also saw a problem in that many of the nations with less gargantuan militaries believe the alliance can only handle a war with one or the other, while Hagel assured it was a time for unity and heavy military investment so NATO could fight a whole bunch of conflicts at once. Ultimately, this split reflects the reality that NATO hasn't had a unified threat since the Cold War ended, and keeping the alliance around for the sake of hostility towards whoever the U.S. is riled up against at any given time is making less and less sense. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports electronics retailer Radio Shack filed for bankruptcy protection on Thursday and said it had a deal in place to sell as many as 2,400 stores to an affiliate of hedge fund Standard General, its lender and largest shareholder. Under an agreement, wireless company Sprint would operate as many as 1,750 of those stores. Radio Shack's bankruptcy, which has been expected for months, follows 11 consecutive unprofitable quarters as the company has failed to transform itself into a destination for mobile phone buyers. But it sells a green